second time a request by Texas to bar relief agencies from bringing Syrian refugees into the state, a decision that could have a bearing on the attempt of 30 other governors to block refugees from their states. U.S. District Judge David Godbee said the Republican leaders who have fought the resettlement have not shown Texas would suffer irreparable harm. The same judge rejected in December the state's request for a restraining order, saying the evidence presented was largely speculative hearsay. Godbee wrote in the decision, "The court does not deny that Syrian refugees pose some risk. That would be foolish. In our country, however, it is the federal executive that is charged with assessing and mitigating that risk, not the states and not the courts." President Obama has pledged to take in 10,000 people fleeing war-torn Syria and has so far admitted 2,000 refugees. Europe is dealing with millions of refugees fleeing conflict in the Middle East and Africa. Since fiscal year 2011, 243 Syrian refugees have resettled in Texas, making the state one of the main U.S. relocation sites since the Syrian Civil War erupted about 5 years ago. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Geneticists gathered at a conference this week to debate the ethics of cloning human beings and compelling them to fight to the death in a rock-filled pit for our amusement. Experts at the conference reportedly discussed questions key to the scientific field, such as the morality of arming hundreds of clones with maces and pitting them against each other on a small platform surrounded by molten lava.
Cloning humans and goading them into viciously battling certainly raises ethical questions. It's important that we consider this topic with an open mind. Whether or not we should be stranding clones on a desert island, assigning them weapons by a lottery system and making them murder one another tournament style remains a matter up for debate.
And in this week's local news, a man is wearing a low-cut swimsuit as though a public pool is some kind of sun-kissed Sardinian cove. In other news, China's veteran reporters blast the decline of traditional state-run journalism. A new study finds human hearing is most acute when listening to arguing parents from the top of the stairs, and fireflies almost managed to salvage a local man's shitty day.
This is the Onion News Network.
It's Free Talk Live. Join us here. We'll give you the toll-free number on this primary day edition, at least for New Hampshire, of Free Talk Live. Joining you in the studio tonight, you've got Ian,
Johnson,
and Mark.
And, of course, we'll give you our toll-free numbers and the Skype username as well. Mark, you've actually got some statistics, I think, about Americans' frustration with both political parties. Is that right?
That's right.
I think that'll be a good one to talk about on today because, you know, it's primary day here in New Hampshire. It's the first primary in all of the 50 states. There was the Iowa caucus already, but this is the first primary. And that's a big deal. You know, a lot of people are paying attention. I actually conducted two interviews this morning with a couple of our radio affiliates, WGMD, FM, in Delaware, and then also KMMS AM out in Bozeman, Montana. So one of them, you know, asked me a lot of questions about New Hampshire and, you know, what are things like here? What are your predictions? And of course, I can't predict, you know, what's going to happen.
How do you describe some place in the United States as compared to other places?
I think it's New Hampshire's a unique place as far as
that's what everybody thinks about their place.
As far as politically is concerned. And I think there's a lot of evidence for that particular claim. In my case, one of the points I made was that in New Hampshire, you can't prejudge people based on their political party as effectively as you can in some other places. So, like, for instance, in New Hampshire, the Republicans, some of the Republican state reps actually voted for gay marriage, and many of the Democrat state reps are gun owners, and they support gun rights. So, you know, not just because you're a Democrat in New Hampshire doesn't mean that you want to have gun control. Just because you're a Republican doesn't mean you're anti-gay marriage. And those are just two examples of a myriad of different things. Like cannabis legalization here was supported by 80% of the state House representatives in the last state House session last year.
Just because you're ordinarily Republican doesn't mean that you don't support free ponies for everyone.
Well, there's Vermin Supreme, and that's a whole other category.
He's not a registered Republican. He was under
that's
the
what I'm saying. Just because you're Republican doesn't mean that you don't support free ponies for everyone.
I see.
So it's just a unique place because it is more of a purple state than it is anything else. Red and blue don't really apply here in the same way that they do in other places.
It's also somewhat less religious. The you know, New England area, the Northeast, tends to be less religious than most. And
at the very least, the people who are religious here are less in your face about it.
No, no. I mean, there's...
There are fewer churches.
Certainly, some studies are done, yeah. And you know, it's just one of those things. So that's going to have an effect on sort of the attitude of the populace.
Well, but I also think that the people who are religious here are less in your face about it. It doesn't have... The religions here, they exist. There are churches, but they don't have that same kind of southern feel to them, the real pushy kind of Christian fundamentalist feel to them.
Well, any group that is sufficiently in the as a minority is going to be more polite. You know what I mean? Like,
okay.
Just generally, that's how that's going to be. So when you have, therefore, up here, you probably have less polite non-religious people in the sense that have more political power.
So I had, as I said, I had two interviews today on the radio talking about the primary, which is always interesting because, like, the first interview, I was amazed they kept me on for as long as they did. I was on for basically 45 minutes out of the hour of the show. They started me at 15 after and took me through the end of the hour.
Were these normal talker shows, or were they like, hey?
They weren't just talk radio shows. Just, I mean, this, the morning shows.
But were they normal? In other words, were they using normal voices, or were they doing radio voices?
It wasn't the morning zoo.
Yeah, I wouldn't say
it doesn't have to be Morning Zoo to be the radio voice.
I wouldn't say they were like particularly extra radio or anything like that. But I was on the phone, so it's hard to really get a real feel for how someone sounds when you're on the phone. But what was interesting to me was, like, you know, I'm no political pundit. I don't know I don't even know who all the candidates are. I mean, I know some of the big names just because you can't not know them in our business. But it's interesting, like, that they wanted to talk to me. And obviously I'm always grateful for the opportunity to, you know, talk to our affiliate stations about whatever the issue happens to be. But by no means do I feel like I'm in any way knowledgeable or have any expertise about the election.
You're a radio guy that lives in New Hampshire.
That was good enough.
Qualified as a pundit as far as the radio guys are concerned.
And I can talk about New Hampshire, and I can talk about things that make it different, and I can talk about the system here. So I explained the undeclared voter. And I think this is one of the most important things for people to understand about New Hampshire is when you look at the polls, a lot of the times they're taking polls of Republicans and Democrats. So when they say that Trump's leading in the polls in New Hampshire, they're talking about, most of the time, from what I've seen, they're talking about a poll that was done of Republican voters, which does not include undeclared voters. And in New Hampshire, undeclared voters, so there's three categories that you can register for in New Hampshire: Republican, Democrat, undeclared. If you are a Libertarian or a Green Party or something like that, you can be in those parties, but you can't register as those with the state.
Right. So there's only three choices.
So most people in New Hampshire, or the plurality of people in New Hampshire who are registered to vote, are undeclared. If you look at the raw numbers, there are more undeclared voters than there are Democrat and then there are Republican. Not combined, but each one of them. So the undeclared is the biggest voting block in New Hampshire. And I don't know how many of the polls actually factor them in. I suspect some do. You know, just simply some people might just ask, who are you voting for? Or are you voting in the Republican or Democrat?
Well, I don't know. I got like about 30 phone calls a night trying to poll me as an undeclared.
Really?
It can be really uncomfortable. I didn't get any.
Really?
Yeah. I have a business. My line's listed as a business line, and I just haven't gotten any.
Huh.
So anyway, I think it's important to explain that to people because, you know, whatever the polls say, maybe they'll pan out the way they say. Maybe the vote will pan out that way. And we'll certainly let you know as the show goes on how things are developing. But ultimately, those undeclared voters are a big question mark, I think, because they can swing an election in any direction. And the undeclared voter in New Hampshire can walk in to the polling location and they tell the people that check them in, I want to declare as a, and then they decide.
Right. They take either ballot.
One of them or the other.
And so there's going to be a lot of people who are undeclared who are going to take a ballot for the Republican Party to vote for Trump or Cruz or whatever. And there's going to be a lot that take a ballot for the Democratic to vote for Bernie. And I've got to say, up here, I believe that it's going to be mostly – undeclareds are mostly going to go for Bernie.
So here's the interesting thing. So I've been undeclared, and I've been getting these phone calls, and I've been getting people showing up at my door and my mailbox full of flyers and just like constant barrage of – you know, who are you going to vote for? Vote for this candidate. Come on, vote. And I got to the point today where I'm thinking about, you know, do I want to go down to the polls and vote? I'm undeclared. I could vote for either party and affect the primary for either party. Do I want to vote? By one vote, I could get in there and have that effect. And I just decided, I'm like, ugh. I was just too disgusted. And I figured, yeah, I'm just not going to bother. And it's been a long time since I haven't gone out to vote.
Mm-hmm.
But,
you just weren't excited enough. There wasn't anyone
I just did not want to go out.
If it had been Ron Paul, would you have gone out?
Ron Paul, yes.
Yeah. So it was interesting. For those of you who are tuned in last night, Rich Paul was on the show, and he and I went at it about Rand Paul towards the end of the program.
Oh,
and of course,
sucks.
I am not a fan of Rand Paul. I'm a critic, and I'm happy to see him out of the race. Rich was advocating.
He's still your favorite Republican in the race. He was still your favorite Republican
in the race. Okay, sure, I'll give you that. But he's definitely not my favorite Republican. But Ron Paul is my favorite Republican.
Okay, second.
I don't know who the other Republicans
at that
are.
Point,
you're a better Republican, in my opinion, Mark. So I'd give you second.
I haven't run for president.
Daryl Perry.
But you are running for political office.
I'm happy to take a write-in vote, and I will give you twice what Bernie Sanders is giving. I'm giving away minimum wage of 15.
Anyway,
I'm going for 30. So hell, why not make it 60?
Rich and I went at it last night in the last hour of the show about, you know, Rand Paul and whether Rand Paul failed the libertarians or the libertarians failed Rand Paul. Of course, I think Rand Paul failed to galvanize any real support, and that's, you know, why I ultimately had to leave, because he had no real support. But further, it was funny because I saw Rich coming out of the ward at which we vote. There's five of them in Keene. We both voted the same ward, and I'm out there doing some exit polling for the Keene Liberty Alliance, and Rich comes out and he says, "Oh man, I forgot that I was still registered as a Democrat from last time." So he couldn't even vote for Rand Paul. He had to vote for Vermin Supreme.
That's funny.
I gave him a high five. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733.
Vermin Supreme's the guy with the rubber boot on his head.
That's right. And you can join us here. Your thoughts certainly on the election are valid. Plus, the post office wants to create a bank. And a happy birthday update.
I have a 70-pound Royal Standard Poodle. Her name is Zelia. And 3 years ago, Zelia's ears were a mess. She would have sticky, gooey, smelly discharge in her ears. We took Zelia to the vet 7 times of $150 every time. The vet offered no success at all. My wife and I are driving, and we hear some people on the radio saying D-I-N-O-V-I-T-E.
859-428-1000. The omega-3 fatty acids.
Flaxseed, zinc, alfalfa.
The digestive enzymes that are cooked out of regular dog food.
6 days after I started feeding her Dinovite, my dog's ear problems were cured. My dog no longer yelps. She can be petted without pain, and it's because Dinovite made our dog healthy again.
859-428-1000.
859-428-1000.
DINOVITE.com.
Are you sneezing, coughing, and aching? Do you have a sore throat, a fever, or the sniffles? There's no reason to be sick this cold and flu season with immune system support from Supernatural Silver. Supernatural Silver can give your body the help it needs to fight off harmful pathogens without hurting beneficial gut flora and without leaving behind resistant bacteria. Antibiotics can damage good microflora and often leave behind bacteria which can cause problems later on. If you're sick of being sick, try Supernatural Silver. Supernatural Silver, the number one choice of thousands for a safe and effective way to protect against the many diseases and illnesses that we are facing today. Go to supernaturalsilver.com, read our customer reviews, and see the life-changing results that people are having. That's supernaturalsilver.com. Supernaturalsilver.com. Use the promo code PROTECTED for 20% off your entire order. And like us on Facebook, Supernatural Silver.
Because we are smothering in spam, please do not reply to all when you can instead reply. I was recently among over 100 invited to a corporate reunion. It's always a warm affair, and that's the problem. Enthusiasm for our upcoming get-together caused many recipients to RSVP the organizer with a cheery reply to all. I can't wait. Then others piled on with a reply to all to that. Then the, I'm out of my office now, autoresponders joined in. So I replied to all, asking that we all reply only to the organizer. Hey, at least I tried. One invitee, apparently retired, shot back, point taken, but I really like seeing the responses since they're so positive. Smiley face. This better be an open bar. From survivalspeech.com, I'm Holland Cook.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
Cryptocurrency and peer-to-peer tech developments happen fast. Stay in the loop with The Daily Decrypt, a new video channel and podcast that will keep you on top of the latest innovations in crypto finance, security, networking, transportation, and gadgetry like drones and 3D printers. Subscribe to The Daily Decrypt on YouTube and SoundCloud and be an early adopter of the future. The Daily Decrypt.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
Talk Live. Join us toll-free here. Our number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Valentine's Day is this Sunday. And if you want a killer gift for Valentine's Day, how about Sherry's Berries? Freshly dipped strawberries of the highest quality from Sherry's Berries. That's what you'll get if you go to berries.com. B-E-R-R-I-E-S. They're dipped in white milk and dark chocolatey goodness, topped with chocolate chips, decorative swizzle, and nuts, and they are delicious.
Yeah, you know, you can get extra mileage out of them by sending them to your loved one's work. Then they get something delivered, you know, and that always looks good.
That's true. It's a great idea. And they'll, of course, ship it wherever you want to, and you can even specify on which day you want it delivered. So if you want it delivered the day before Valentine's Day or whatever, that's fine too. But go to berries.com, click the microphone in the top right, type in code FTL. That way they know we sent you, and you'll be able to get Sherry's Berries starting at just $19.99. Freshly dipped strawberries from Sherry's Berries. And if you add in $10 more, you'll double the berries, which I highly recommend. The more berries, the merrier, as far as I'm concerned. These things are delicious. And the only way somebody would not like this gift is if for some reason they don't like strawberries or chocolate. And if that's the case, then don't worry. Sherry's Berries has all kinds of other delicious treats from which you can choose. So go to berries.com. Start browsing after you type in code FTL, after you click the microphone in the top right. Berries, berries.com. Again, Valentine's Day is coming up this Sunday. Get your order in right now. Otherwise, you'll have to pay more for shipping if you wait too long. So do it now. Berries.com. Click the mic, code FTL, and get the deals. All right, so we're going to continue here. If you want to comment on the election or whatever, you're certainly welcome to do that. And that's kind of where we were starting here tonight. Mark, I know you've got a story about a lot of Americans saying that both the political parties are too corrupt. And I want to get into those details, but just sort of recapping the day today. It was interesting because I was on the radio talking about New Hampshire and, you know, what makes it special and how sort of the political system works here, and that it's hard to really know in advance what's going to happen. Will New Hampshire predict what ends up happening in the long run nationwide? Not necessarily.
Well, it's not 100%.
It's hit and miss over the years.
It's better with Republicans basically than it is with Democrats.
Is that right?
And there's some ways that you can look at, there's different areas in New Hampshire you can look that tend to be better guides and that sort of thing.
Well, in this case, Bernie Sanders seems to be the choice, at least for the west side of the state where we live. That's what I see everywhere is Bernie signs, Bernie bumper stickers. You
Bernie's
hardly ever see
clearly
Hillary.
Going to take it. But the question is by how much, and yeah. that's going to matter for sort of the rest of the election. The you know Hillary's leading in South Carolina, and that's the next one.
Hillary was the only thing that was inspiring me to potentially vote today, and I didn't.
So you'd vote against her? Would be the idea.
I loathe Hillary so much.
Well, I
apparently
don't
not enough.
Yeah, I don't think she's going to win New Hampshire, but
I also didn't think that she was going to win. So.
She may have a stronger showing in the South. So if Bernie takes New Hampshire, it's not necessarily going to mean that he's going to win nationwide.
I mean, this is his New Hampshire's Vermont's backyard, right? Yeah.
So you know, there's all that going on. And then I was doing the Keen Liberty Alliance outreach, which, Johnson, you and I have engaged in. And mm-hmm. this is a way to connect with people who want to see smaller government. They think the government is too large. And it's interesting doing this outreach because you meet all kinds of people. And some of them don't like you because you're a libertarian and they don't like that. But others do. And it was cool because I got to meet some of our listeners. When I'm out there, I've got my voice and people who listen to the show, right. Some of them will recognize it. And so I met some elderly ladies who were very, very sweet and very nice, including one lady who lives right down the street from the studio. And, you know, they listen to Free Talk Live on Saturday nights here in town. And so it was kind of cool to get to, you know, get to meet some of our listeners when I was out there. And then every now and then when this is what I'm doing for listeners that are unaware is I basically everybody that leaves the polling location, I ask them, would you have time for a quick one-question exit survey? And who doesn't have time for a quick one-question exit survey? Most people will stop and they'll let you ask the question. So I will ask, well, do you think the government is too big, too small, or just the right size? And this is actually an old Harry Brown question from way back when. Harry Brown was the Libertarian Party presidential candidate in the year 1996 and 2000. And a super majority of people think the government is too big, at least that took the quiz.
You asked that question with a lot more energy than Harry Brown's sort of version would be like, do you think the government's too big, too small, or just the right size?
So I got a lot of response. He was great. And I got a lot of response for too big. Like the super majority of respondents was too big. Only like a few people said that the government was too small, and a handful said that the government was just the right size.
That's the strangest of them. How could the government possibly be just the right size? I mean, that's pretty...
That just means the person is content.
Goldilocks zone of government.
It's really weird.
I mean, I'm always content. Don't rock the boat ever.
So was it just the right size 5 years ago when it was smaller? And
So anyway, then when that happens, when the person says the government's too big, then that's, you know, essentially that's the prospect. That's the person mm-hmm. who I want to talk to. That's the person who I want to communicate with. And so then I pitch the idea of, you know, them sharing their email address so we can get them in an email group and that kind of thing. But sometimes it's interesting the variety of responses you'll get. Sometimes people will stop me before I'll ask the question and they'll say, who are you with? And then as soon as I say Keen Liberty Alliance, they just start walking away. Even though Keen Liberty Alliance means nothing. I mean, it's like it's a very unknown group here. It's not like people know what the Keen Liberty Alliance is. But
I don't like that word, liberty.
Right. I think it's people who don't like the word liberty.
You must be a Republican.
Or no, you must be a libertarian or
well,
you must be a free stater.
A lot of times it's Democrats that don't like Republicans because Republicans use the liberty word.
Could
a lot,
be. Sometimes, though, you'll get someone who will say the government is too big. But then they'll say, are you the free staters? And I'll say, yeah, I'm a free stater. And then they'll just walk away. So not everybody who likes small government likes the free staters either. So there's a wide variety of responses.
You just want small government so you can have topless Tuesday.
Well, actually, one guy made some sort of quip after he was walking away why don't you go bug some meter maids or something like that.
Oh, my God.
Today's not meter maid day.
Yeah.
Today's not meter maid day.
So anyway, it's fun.
Ian, making friends in Keene.
Actually, a lot of people were very friendly today, Mike.
I bet there were
definitely going to be people that are friendly, especially for some things. Like
you're standing in front of them.
Weed in the Central Square Day, you know, that's going to win friends.
So this is
not
something
voters.
That people need to understand, though, about being an activist, is that when you're an activist and you're visible, people are going to have opinions about you.
They sure are.
I'm sorry, the not winning voters thing. I went out to lunch, and I've got a grease stain on my shirt, unfortunately, mm-hmm. from I got a sandwich today from a local sub shop. And when I went in to the sub shop, as I was going in to get my sandwich, there was a guy sitting there in a cowboy hat, first of all, which is just a little strange here in mm-hmm. Keene. And he was wearing a shirt that said, ask me why cops either are or should be against
drugs.
Against marijuana. Ask me why cops should be for marijuana legalization.
He sounds like he's one of the law enforcement against prohibition.
Yeah, he certainly looked like it. I mean, that's what it's. I mean, that's
you didn't ask him, huh?
I didn't know. I was like, I had to go and go. You know, it's like I don't have a lot of time. So,
toll free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Mark's going to tell us about the majority of Americans saying both parties are too corrupt. It's Free Talk Live.
Are you looking to sell body armor? Want to make extra money selling body armor at your local gun shows? With low minimum buys and great returns, KD Armor is the answer. Make money in your spare time. It's American-made body armor with the quickest turnaround in the industry, which means you get your product when you need it at very competitive rates. And they'll ship it to you for free. If you own a business, give them a call today at 855-488-KD. That's 855-488-2284. Or go to KDArmor.com. Come and take it.
Water is the single most important thing your body needs, so you want to be sure it's the best for you and your family. Since 2005, thousands have depended on Berkey purified water. The Berkey guy provides the lowest priced filtration systems in every size. For incredibly delicious water now and in an emergency, get to GoBerkey.com or call 877-886-3653. 877-886-3653. GoBerkey.com.
Free Talk Live.
When a deer approaches a marijuana plant in the woods and nibbles off one of the buds, is that sad? Is that deer living a sad state of existence?
I have no idea. I've never heard of an animal eating something that would.
Christy, that's because you have no idea what you're talking about. You don't know one thing about cannabis. You don't know anything about it.
I understand that you want to partake of that drug.
Oh, I do. Trust me.
Listen, I understand that you should have the right to do that.
Well, thank you.
Where it's legal. Where it's legal.
Oh. Since the beginning of time, human beings and other animals have been altering their state of consciousness. Believe it or not, it's not just a human being thing.
Robins eat elderberries in the fall and get drunk on them.
Yes, so this is a common thing amongst the various different creatures of this earth.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is your Robertson Roberts Brokerage Daily Precious Metals Update. On Tuesday, gold is $2 higher at $1,192 per ounce. Silver is up 4 cents at $15.39 per ounce. Bitcoin is trading at $375. We're offering up to 200 gold American Eagle 10th-ounce coins for $60 off the usual ounce price each. Call us and ask about this special at 800-874-9760 or visit us online at rrbi.co.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love, but make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
Hi, I'm Derek J. I don't want a politician to represent me. To me, government is the idea that one group of people can coerce everyone to comply with an edict or face increasing punishments up to and including death. Despite perhaps the most noble of intentions, the best government services are a far cry from what could be provided for by voluntary interactions. Besides, the people who call themselves the government wage wars and put peaceful people in jail for crimes involving no victims. If Starbucks used some of its money to drop bombs, I wouldn't shop there. So why would I support the American Empire? The Empire does not require my consent.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at VictimlessCrimeSpree.com. That's VictimlessCrimeSpree.com.
You can put the Liberty Radio Network on the air in your area. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how. Broadcast.lrn.fm.
We'll be right back.
Free Talk Live. Join us on the radio waves here. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. The internet was meant to be used anonymously, if you want, and without oversight. But many governments and companies are thriving off the lack of privacy that you have on the internet today. ProXPN can give you that privacy back. ProXPN is a virtual private network, and they encrypt your data right from your computer or mobile device. And ProXPN offers OpenVPN, the gold standard of network encryption, with apps for Windows, Mac, iOS, Android, and there's Linux support too. Unlike other VPNs, ProXPN keeps no logs of your activities whatsoever, and with more servers being added all the time, ProXPN works hard to give you greater speed and security compared to other VPNs. If you're a Windows user, ask ProXPN about changing your DNS settings for even greater anonymity. They accept credit card and even Bitcoin. And if you use the code FTL50, you can get 50% off their regular monthly price for the lifetime of an annual account. It can end up being cheaper per month than a good cup of coffee. And for privacy, that's a pretty darn good deal. Use the internet the way it was meant to be used. Go to proxpn.com right now. Use code FTL50 and take back the privacy that is your right. That's proxpn.com with code FTL50. With you tonight, it's Ian.
And Johnson.
And Mark.
And let's continue, Mark, since we're talking about voting. Of course, it's primary night here in New Hampshire. We'll give you some numbers on that as the show rolls on. It's too early right now to really talk about it because voting polling locations just closed at the beginning of the show at 7 o'clock Eastern time. But you wanted to share what Americans as a whole, Mark, think about the political parties, the two big political parties. What is it that Americans are saying?
Well, apparently, according to Washington'sblog.com, overwhelming majority of Americans believe that both parties are too corrupt to change anything. So, that's a pretty impressive indictment, right? Like, they're too corrupt to change anything.
Yep, okay.
And I think this is why people like Sanders and Trump are getting so much mileage right now from their campaigns is they're not viewed as part of either of these parties.
By the by, it's not too soon to start reporting on what's going on because I have numbers already from Google. 1% of precincts are reporting.
It's
and we
too
have
soon.
Numbers.
1% is too soon.
What?
You're talking about Dixville Notch and a couple other places with like five people that vote, and that happens at midnight. So those numbers have been available.
No, it's more than that. At this point, they have reported more than that, but it's still when it comes to these numbers, you can watch them as they pile up in this over the next hour. But on the radio,
they tend to trend very early. I mean, thin slicing. It's just.
I disagree.
I don't think it's worth reporting. I mean,
I agree.
Not this show.
Too soon.
Going back here. So it says, we previously noted in polls that Americans were in a pre-revolutionary mood, less than one in five. Okay, so fewer than one in five Americans think that the government has the consent of the governed, that government corruption tops the list of Americans' fears, and that three times as many Americans supported King George during the Revolutionary War that support our own Congress today.
Whoa. Read that last one again. Three times as many Americans
supported King George during the U.S. Revolution than do support Congress today.
That's got to be per capita. It can't be by flat numbers.
Right. I'm sure.
Interesting.
So
who was doing polling way back when? That's interesting.
It's just they're just taking the 33% number that you learned in school.
Hear ye, hear ye. Bringeth thy exit numbers yonder.
So group of Republican and Democratic pollsters and political strategists reviewed polling data last week and revealed some stunning results. 84% of all Americans believe political leaders are more interested in protecting their power and privilege than doing what is right. That one seems just obvious, right? Like, that's what politician means. Somebody who's more interested in protecting their power than they are in doing what's the right thing. And these are the people, by the way, that write the laws. And then people say, it's a nation of laws. Well, how can it be a nation of laws if the people that are writing them are corrupt? That's what this is sort of what I need to understand. Exactly what do you mean when you say these things? So this is the complicated part of it, is that I've been called un-American more times than I care to be called anything in the last month. Just, a couple of videos have gotten out, and I don't know exactly what it is, but people have called me un-American.
Okay.
Exactly what does that mean? when the government is as corrupt as it is, and that's really what America is its government. Well, how can you be anything but an American?
Is America its government, or is America a plot of land and the United States is the government?
Okay, fine. America's a plot of land. Who doesn't like land? I mean, like, there are people that dislike dirt. I don't hate dirt.
Well, you
dirt.
Can't you be in favor of America, the land and the people, but not in favor of the government of the United States?
Well, I think you can, but I have some questions regarding that. Should I like people from Seattle more than I like people from British Columbia?
Do I have to be in favor of the land and the people? What if I just like the people and I don't really like the land?
Yeah, or the vice versa.
But I mean, land?
Yeah, I mean, but I'm just trying to figure out what un-American means, right? Like,
I don't know what it means either. It doesn't mean
you're against the government. Does it mean you're against the people? Does it mean you're against the land? Does it mean you're against all three?
It is a thoughtless. It is a thoughtless pejorative, is what it is.
Or does it mean that you disagree with me, and so therefore I don't like you?
That's mostly what it means. It is a way that that a person no longer has to think about the things that you're saying.
Sure.
So I refuse to call myself un-American because I don't know what it means. Mm. I think that I'm, disagreeing with the political process makes me very American.
Well, then your very first answer anytime somebody says that should be, what does it mean to be American?
I try to ask these questions, but then they say I'm stupid. Right? Like, it's stupid. That's a stupid thing to say. You just want to start arguments and stuff like that.
Well, actually, it's kind of stupid to call someone un-American if you can't define what American means. Just challenge them on that.
Sure.
Yeah. If you've got an answer as to what un-American means or America means or any of these things, you can give us a call at 855-450-3733.
You don't like apple pie.
Right. I think it's great. I prefer it with ice cream.
That's un-American.
No, it's
only
very American.
Americans eat it without the ice cream.
Is that so?
I have no idea.
No, you have no idea. No, I mean,
what about whipped
meaningless.
Cream?
But I do prefer blueberry pie to apple pie.
Same too. Same
and
here.
Pumpkin pie.
Berries are in.
Oh,
as far as the flavor
pumpkin
goes.
Pumpkin pie over apple pie.
Pumpkin pie.
That's un-American.
Any day.
Yeah, I don't think so.
Absolutely.
Pumpkin pie.
Blueberry
is...
pie. I could let you slide on. I can't do the pumpkin pie over
really?
The apple pie. I like pumpkin pie. I just can't say pumpkin pie over apple pie. That's that's blasphemy. That'd be like saying you like strawberry rhubarb pie over everything else. That's
what flavor
crazy.
Ice cream do you get when you go to the ice cream store?
I like cookies and cream and sometimes mint chocolate chip.
Okay. Yeah, mint chocolate chip's good.
At least there's some excitement to what you're saying. Yeah. I mean, the worst pumpkin pie you've ever had isn't that much worse than the best pumpkin pie you've ever had.
This is true.
It's a consistently sort of boring thing. You know, we're not talking about, whoa. That's
pumpkin
some
pie
good...
is old people food. It's like, yum, 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 pumpkin
people
pie.
Without teeth. Yeah. 81% of Americans
at least get like a lemon custard pie in there or something. You
that's
know, like,
a, quite a tang. You've got to one way or the other.
It's not as tangy as key lime.
That's true. 81% of Americans believe that the power of ordinary people to control our country is getting weaker every day as politicians of both parties fight to protect their own power and privilege.
All right. 80-something percent?
81%. I mean, a devastating majority of Americans believe that they really are politically powerless. And they're right.
By the way, the party system that we have right now in this country makes your options for pies both feces pie. You either get, one pie is like one type of feces and the other pie is another type of feces. And you get to select between both. That's your choice.
When you vote.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah. There's no time as a
I don't like
more true.
Feces pie.
But yet it makes people feel like they have some effect. They came out in droves today, by the way. I mean, spent basically the afternoon. I was there from 2 until 6:30 tonight outside at the polls. It was cold and it was busy the entire time. It's very rare that I'll go to a primary and actually have to stand in a line to get my ballot. Today there was a small line that I had to stand in the middle of the day. And so people still feel like they should go out. They still feel like they should participate, even though at the same time the numbers say that they know it's fruitless. It's pointless. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. You can share your thoughts on the statistics and what Americans think. It's Free Talk Live.
All right, listen up, because this is the most important thing you're going to hear all day. What if I said you could make money flipping houses without any cash, credit, or manual labor? And what if I said you could do it part-time from the comfort of your home? Sound unflippin' believable? Hi, I'm Preston Ealy, and I'm going to prove it by sending you a free copy of my smash hit-selling book, How to Get Rich in Real Estate. It sells online for $19.95, but I'm giving away 5,000 free copies this week. To get one before they're gone, call 1-800-961-8439. I used to be so broke, I had my electricity shut off 9 times. But I figured out a simple way to make money flipping houses without even breaking a sweat. Now I'm living the good life, and so should you. Listen, if you're sick and tired of stressing about money, this book could change your life. Hands down, it's the fastest, easiest way to get started in real estate. Let me prove it. Call right now to find out how to get your free book. When they're gone, they're gone. Call 1-800-961-8439. 1-800-961-8439.
It's about time something new came along for better selling and buying online. And I found it.
What now, Marge?
It's buysellmakeoffer.com.
Never heard of it.
It's a brand new company. That's why you've never heard of it. It's the newest and best way to sell any products online. I did all the research.
Sell my car?
Yes.
Our home?
Yep.
My golf bag?
Your golf clubs. All of them.
How about your purse collection hoard?
Hey, now.
You said any product.
Right. I did. We get 30 days free.
Really?
Packages starting from only $7.95. And buysellmakeoffer.com will never charge item fees, ever. Never. And this is cool. Listen to this. You can even use Skype or video to show your items.
That's cool.
Yes. All we have to do is go to the website, sign up, and then load our stuff to sell. I love this site.
Buysellmakeoffer.com.
Buysellmakeoffer.com. You got it?
Buysellmakeoffer.com.
Buysellmakeoffer.com. Better selling, better buying.
If you are successful at what you do, whether you're a doctor, a lawyer, a business owner, or you have a great career, you understand the concept of protecting yourself. Well, are you protecting yourself, your family, and your assets with quality term life insurance? Consider these possible rates. A man age 45, non-tobacco user, could obtain $1 million of coverage for as little as $75 a month. And this rate is fixed for the next 10 years. We specialize in policies of $500,000 and above. A man aged 50, non-tobacco user, may be able to obtain $500,000 of coverage for as little as $115 a month. And this rate is fixed for the next 20 years. We have great rates for smokers, too. Call the Term Lifeline now. 800-872-0403. 800-872-0403. 800-872-0403.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308. The new 4th edition of Healing Our World, The Compassion of Libertarianism will take your understanding of liberty to a deeper level and has over 1,300 updated references, new cartoons, and a foreword by Dr. Ron Paul. With discounts for multiple book purchases, the 4th edition of Healing Our World is a great gift for the liberals, pragmatists, environmentalists, and Christians in your life who think libertarianism is cold-hearted. Get yours today at healing.freetalklive.com and use promo code FTL for a $5 discount.
You can connect with the Liberty Radio Network via our Facebook page at facebook.lrn.fm. That's facebook.lrn.fm.
Yeah! Free Talk Live. Dial in if you want to join us here. It is the first primary in the United States for 2016 New Hampshire, which happens to be where we're located, here in beautiful Keene. With you tonight, you've got Ian.
And Johnson.
And Mark.
Don't forget, you can join us online anytime you want at freetalklive.com. You can help support Free Talk Live. Maybe you like the fact that we bring to you 7 nights a week live radio content of a pro-liberty nature. And we're doing it on over 160 radio stations from coast to coast. You appreciate that? Well, you can help us out by becoming an amplifier at amp.freetalklive.com. Just go to amp.freetalklive.com, and that is where you can sign up for $5 a month with any major credit card. You can use Visa or MasterCard right there on our website. You can use any credit card through PayPal. You can use Bitcoin to sign up as well, and that helps us get Free Talk Live on more radio stations, which we will hopefully be adding some new ones here shortly. It's been actually a pretty good month. Within the last month, we've added Dallas and some other markets. So thank you to everyone who's a Free Talk Live amplifier. You guys make a huge difference for us, and we really appreciate it. In fact, right now it's actually been a really good last 24 hours for Free Talk Live, because as far as the affiliate relations side of things go, calling new radio stations, Hugh Hewitt, who is a talk show host who has an evening show, he's kind of like a right-wing Christian conservative guy.
Host debates or something like recently?
Yeah, I believe he was in one of those.
He's gotten a little bit of press recently for being, you know, I don't know, gotten mentioned during the primary season.
So he's been one of our competitors at nighttime for a while here, actually pretty much the whole time we've been doing the show. And he recently just got announced like on Monday that he was going to be moving his show to a morning show slot. He's going to be replacing Bill Bennett, who is the former drug czar from, I believe, the Clinton administration, maybe Reagan. I don't remember when. He was a drug czar at some point, and so this former drug czar is retiring from radio, and this other guy who's our competition is leaving nights, which means that now Free Talk Live is, and this was a little shocking for me, is the longest running show in our day part, in our time slot, in syndication. We've been there longer in this day part than any other show out there. Mark Levin, we've been there longer than he has, and he's the big boy that we're competing against. Jerry,
he's the ones that are backed by the you know, the big corporations and stuff.
Right. Jerry Doyle, who's a former guy from Babylon 5, he's been doing a nighttime talk show, but he's only been doing evenings for a little while, and so he's been doing it for a long time, just a few months longer in syndication than we have, but we've been doing our show for longer than he has.
Well, you just let me know when we're revising that talker's ad.
Yep. So that's a big deal, I think. The fact that we are like a mainstay in nighttime talk radio at this point. We are the longest running syndicated.
That's a great little thing
Great thing to be able to claim.
So yeah, so thank you to everybody who's helped make all that possible, because it's our listeners who've become amplifiers that have helped put us in this position and continue to make it possible for us to spread the ideas of freedom as far and as wide as possible. So go to amp.freetalklive.com. Mark, you were sharing with us some statistics from, I'm sorry, I don't recall what the polling firm...
Washingtonsblog.com.
...was. I suspect they're reporting on an actual polling firm.
Yeah, they're putting things together in a way that just sort of show the dissatisfaction Americans have with their government.
So they're looking at different polls then?
They're putting some stuff together. Okay. So it says here, a group of Republicans and Democrats, pollsters and political strategists reviewed polling data last week and revealed some stunning results. And we've already gone through a couple of them here, but this one, 80% of Americans believe the federal government is its own special interest, primarily looking out for itself.
Yep. Okay.
So, I mean, they see this clearly. Now, they may want things from the federal government or whatever. They haven't come to the conclusions that maybe you or I have, which is that, hey, an organization this big, this corrupt, with the power to force you to fund it, is not salvageable. Like, it's just not a model that you want.
They haven't gotten to that point. They know that it's bad, but they still probably believe that Bernie's going to be a revolution, or Trump's going to get in there and he's anti-establishment.
And I think that that is the best answer. Now, I did say, I predicted it way back in like 2005 that you would see the Republican Party split in 2012, and I kind of get some credit for predicting the Tea Party revolution. So
didn't that happen before 2012?
But that's when it came into mattering and on a national level. The Tea Party came in.
Didn't really split anything though, right?
Well, tell the establishment Republicans that
they're doing just fine. The establishment Republicans are established. What are you saying happened in 2012?
I expected the Republican Party to split into two parties.
It didn't.
It didn't split into two parties, but it has two huge factions now. Yes.
What are the factions?
The Tea Party and not the Tea Party.
Okay.
And that's kind of it.
Do you see this when you go to Republican meetings?
What do you mean? I don't go to that. These factions? Republican meetings.
Well, what makes you say they have two factions?
Because that's what the media's reporting. What do you want?
Okay, but you don't have any personal experience with
it. What, that there are Tea Party people?
That there are two factions.
Yeah, there are factions, sure.
Okay. I'm just curious about this because I don't know if I believe you.
I don't know if I believe that either. Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, you'll have people like like, you know, who's Tea Party? Palin?
Yep, who's, Palin's, you know, one of the part of the Tea Party. So is Ted
Cruz.
She's
establishment. He's Cruz's, establishment.
Cruz's. As you define establishment, not as normal folks define establishment.
Are you telling me Ted Cruz, a senator, is not a, it is not an establishment candidate funded by Goldman Sachs? I mean, we just explained Ron Paul last night called Ted Cruz out and said Bernie Sanders is more libertarian than Ted Cruz.
Look, I mean, all this tells me that there's a lot of really gullible Republicans, you know.
Well, like, it does, oh, and Democrats. It doesn't. I mean, yeah. they're all gullible, Ian. The political process. People aren't going to ever get educated in the political process. That's just not the nature of government, right? I mean, when you give everybody a vote, then what you're saying, you're mandating that people that have that are less that are below average, half of the people are going to be below average. Why would you care what they have to say? Well, that's what the democratic process is.
I like how I said they were gullible and he just starts attacking you. I could just say things and Mark will just take it out on you.
Chum in the water. I just want to know from someone who's in the Republican Party, who's active within it, if what you're saying is true, Mark. Because I know there are people who are active
in the Republican Party that were not active in it prior to the Tea Party Revolution. People who have signed on to this. This is what they now self-identify as.
But that doesn't mean they're any kind of force. That doesn't mean there's a split. I know that in 2012 and 2008, there were obviously people supporting Ron Paul who had some difficult times trying to sort of get involved in the Republican Party and support Ron Paul. And they, you know, shut them out and turn off their microphones and didn't let them into the party conventions and things like that. That was the only time when at least I'd heard something about
That's not a schism, Ian, because the Ron Paul people didn't create anything. A schism is where people with power, some kind of power, are able to split. The organization. So I would say the Republican Party has been split in that establishment Republicans, people who are in power, who've been in power for 20 years, say, I can't handle these new types of Republicans because they don't want to work with the Democrats. This isn't what politics is about. Politics is about compromise, and they don't want to compromise.
Well, since when did Republicans, like standard Republicans, not elected ones, since when did regular Republicans want to work with Democrats? That's never been the case.
The complaint that Rush
Limbaugh... That's why they're Republicans. That's why the Democrats are Democrats. They don't want to work with the other party.
Well, okay, so it's difficult when you start moving the goalposts. So were the goalposts, were we talking about politicians or were we talking about voters?
When I was talking about Republicans, we were talking about voters. Are you saying there was a schism between the politicians? Because who cares about that? You made it sound like there were two chunks of the party, which when I think of the party, I'm thinking of the party, which is the majority, which is the people.
Okay, so I would say that the Republican voters, the grassroots voters, are more interested in the Tea Party, and therefore, when they've gotten some Tea Party candidates in and they've beaten some establishment or moderate Republicans, they're very, very much behind those people, and that the establishment or moderate Republicans are upset and scared about this inside the party, the politicians,
ones, the high end operatives.
So if I wasn't clear, that I'm talking about basically the people who are elected are scared of their electorate to some extent.
Okay. So that's making it a little more clear now.
I predicted a split between sort of the libertarian faction and the Jerry Falwell faction. That didn't happen, but there was a split in the Republican Party. Now, I don't remember exactly what I was getting to when you derailed me about my split here. So 80%
I'm glad we figured out that you were wrong. Go ahead.
How can you ever be right with a prediction? You don't make predictions.
No, you just sit
over there and bring the show in and bring it out. You rely on me to make these kind of things.
I don't ask you to do anything like that.
No, you don't. I just got to make the show interesting. 80% believe the federal government is its own special interest, primarily looking out for itself, is what we were discussing.
Toll free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And you can join us on the radio here. You can talk about whatever happens to be on your mind. Once there's a few percentage points in worth sharing with you from the New Hampshire primary, probably going to be closer to 9 o'clock Eastern when that'll happen. It's at 2% as of last check as far as the precincts reporting in. You can share your thoughts, 855-450-FREE.
As a pioneer of the e-commerce movement, Overstock.com is proud to be the first major retailer to accept Bitcoin. Overstock was the first because Patrick Byrne, Overstock's CEO and founder, firmly believes in personal freedom and cryptocurrency. Over the past 16 years, Overstock has furnished over 18 million homes with a diverse line of products to suit everyone's unique styles and preferences. Support Overstock and freedom of choice while enjoying free shipping on orders of 0.211 Bitcoin or more.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust, who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom. And with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
Currency is too important a thing to be left in the hands of government bureaucrats, especially when billions of dollars can be created with the swipe of a pen. Overstock.com supports the cryptocurrency movement because it returns the power of an inflation-proof form of money to the people, where it belongs. Did you know that you can use Bitcoin to pay for anything Overstock.com sells while enjoying free shipping on orders of 0.211 Bitcoin or more? If you support freedom and the cryptocurrency movement, you should support Overstock.com. Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Tuesday, February 9th, 2016. Silver is trading at $15.34 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,197 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $376. Antiwar.com reports, fulfilling a campaign pledge to end his nation's involvement, Canadian Prime Minister Justin Trudeau has announced that all Canadian airstrikes against the Islamic State in Iraq and Syria will end by February 22nd at the latest. Trudeau campaigned heavily last year on his promise to end Canadian airstrikes, a position that grew in popularity amid reports that the Canadian Defense Ministry had covered up allegations of civilians killed in the airstrikes. Among the Canadian airstrikes, the deadliest to be made public was an attack against a dairy, which Canadian officials claimed was a weapons factory. That strike killed 10 civilian workers and wounded 20 others. Though the U.S. was seen as annoyed at Canada ending its airstrikes, the Pentagon on Monday ignored the report and instead announced that Canada had promised to triple the number of ground troops they are committing to northern Iraq. At present, Canada has up to 70 ground troops in Iraq, so the tripling will mean at most another 140 Canadian troops. Canadian trainers have been involved in some high-profile clashes with the Islamic State troops in the past, though are believed to have been moved back away from the frontier since then. For nearly 40 years, Roberts & Roberts Brokerage has been a trusted source for buying and selling precious metals like gold and silver. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and have permanently removed the minimum purchase amount for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on buying and selling precious metals and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 800-874-9760 or visit online at rrbi.co. UPI reports a winter storm is expected to bring 3 to 8 inches of snow throughout most of Massachusetts, as neighboring New Hampshire could see some snow ahead of presidential primaries. Blizzard conditions are expected in Cape Cod, southeastern Massachusetts, and its islands. Many schools in the state, including those in Boston, Cambridge, Arlington, Chelsea, Salem, and Barnstable, were not open on Monday. Massachusetts Governor Charlie Baker closed state offices in eastern Massachusetts for non-emergency personnel in anticipation of the storm. Some cities cities in Massachusetts introduced parking bans on Monday. In Boston, where between 8 to 12 inches of snow is expected, the snow began falling between 4 and 6 a.m., and the heaviest snowfall is predicted between 7 a.m. and 2 p.m. At least two flights have been canceled from Boston's Logan International Airport. In New Hampshire, where presidential primaries are scheduled for Tuesday, a snowstorm recently brought up to 10 inches of snow in some areas. A winter weather advisory is active throughout the state, with the possibility of light snowfall throughout much of New Hampshire on Tuesday. There is a 20% chance of precipitation on Tuesday in Manchester, the state's largest city, and a temperature of 29 degrees. In Woodstock, there's a 20% chance of snow and a 30-degree high. The Daily Decrypt is a Monday through Friday newscast about all the best news in cryptocurrencies and peer-to-peer networks. Know what's hot in the world of digital money, borderless trade, and cutting-edge communications. Available on YouTube, SoundCloud, and Facebook Video. The Daily Decrypt is the news of the future. Reuters reports a U.S. federal judge denied for the second time a request by Texas to bar relief agencies from bringing Syrian refugees into the state, a decision that could have a bearing on the attempt of 30 other governors to block refugees from their states. U.S. District Judge David Godbee said the Republican leaders who have fought the resettlement have not shown Texas would suffer irreparable harm. The same judge rejected in December the state's request for a restraining order, saying the evidence presented was largely speculative hearsay. Godbee wrote in the decision, "The court does not deny that Syrian refugees pose some risk. That would be foolish. In our country, however, it is the federal executive that is charged with assessing and mitigating that risk, not the states and not the courts." President Obama has pledged to take in 10,000 people fleeing war-torn Syria and has so far admitted 2,000 refugees. Europe is dealing with millions of refugees fleeing conflict in the Middle East and Africa. Since fiscal year 2011, 243 Syrian refugees have resettled in Texas, making the state one of the main U.S. relocation sites since the Syrian civil war erupted about 5 years ago. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
The chimpanzee spends most of its day in the jungle, carelessly swinging from tree to tree and picking mites off itself. Instead of building shelter and teaching itself how to read, this chimp is named Bolo. And researchers at Duke University have shown that he can solve three-dimensional logic puzzles, an impressive feat indeed, until you learn that human children as young as three are also able to solve the puzzle. Even a mentally handicapped human is capable of verbal speech, something no chimpanzee has ever been able to accomplish, despite working vocal cords capable of howling in irritation after soiling itself. Chimps have been observed using tools, but their tools are little more than sticks. Even driving and preparing pancakes, tasks we leave to the stupidest, least educated humans, lay beyond the capabilities of the chimp.
This is the Onion News Network.
It's Free Talk Live. Dial toll-free to join us here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We've got Skype as well. The Skype username is lrn.fm, and you can join us online anytime you want. Get interactive and create the content right there on the front page of the website. You can put stuff on our site, and then other listeners can vote whether they like or dislike. So get interactive over at freetalklive.com. There's been a lot of discussion about the election, political process, the parties, and how Americans are frustrated. And I think we're still in the middle of the story that you have, Mark, about Americans overwhelmingly, like 80% or whatever, lots of Americans are frustrated with the two-party system. They believe that both parties are just corrupt beyond repair, that Washington, D.C. cannot be fixed.
That's what they're basically saying here. But the most exciting news from today's primary here in New Hampshire is that a pig got loose in Pelham, New Hampshire, and went down to the polling place.
Nice. And they tried to capture it, huh?
Yeah, well, the cops tried to capture it, and then it was biting the cops.
And there's video?
Yeah, there's video.
Have you shared it on our Facebook page yet?
I did. There's a it's video of us on our Facebook page at facebook.freetalklive.com. You can go there. A 600-pound sow chasing
her.
Yeah, she's a big girl. There's not there's no human being that is going to stop her. You stop that animal with love and respect. You don't stop it with anything but a bullet. Other than that,
wow.
So
is it still on the loose, or did they get
it? No, the farmer came, and it was really kind of funny. So she was chasing the cops around, trying to bite the cops, and then she,
pig bites pig.
What's that?
Pig bites pig.
Well, you can see whatever you want. So, but then the farmer shows up, and she just kind of goes up there and nuzzles his hand. And she's like, "Oh, daddy." You know, so, he's the one who brings he brings the food.
Are you guys talking about the results yet?
No, not yet. We're going to go to the
results. You know that Google's calling it already. Like, they're already calling who's won at 6% polling.
You can't call who's won at 6%.
I'm sure that you can at 6% because the leads are huge.
The lead from Trump is huge at this point.
And the lead from Sanders is pretty huge, too.
Well, yeah. I mean, the chances that Trump and Sanders are going to win, no one's really arguing that. The question is, by how much?
I don't think it's fair. I mean, it's not fair to call anything at 6%. I mean, it could be that, like, for instance...
Now.
Like, for instance, the Keene area is a more lefty area of the state. Sanders is going to do better in Keene than he would in some of the more righty areas of the state, for instance.
When they call it, they're rarely wrong.
Yeah.
All right. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We'll get into that. But first, David's on the line in California. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, David.
Hey, Ian. Mark, you know, I heard you talk. Oh, by the way, your network news, at least GCN's network news, claimed that it's Trump and Bernie.
Yeah.
So yes. They called it already. You know, I heard you talking about the GOP and their split. Mark's basically right. I mean, they've been split. In some ways, you could say it's an Ike and Mike, but I would actually put it a little more in an educated way. If you remember all the way back to Richard Nixon days, he had a political strategy that if for every political issue, always turn the issue to the right. Now, when you think about that, there's just walking off the cliff point. And so when you take a whole bunch of, whether you call them establishment Republicans or you just take the educated class, for people to own bridges, you know, we the people own the bridges, we own the sewer systems, we own the libraries and the schools and everything else, and for a fashion of politics to say that all government is bad and that we should never reinvest in our roads or bridges or libraries or schools or fresh water and that we should all let it collapse and let the free market take over, that's preposterous. And so there's this difference between whether or not we want to reinvest in our own property or whether we're going to privatize everything and then let, you know, the buyer beware when it comes to drinking water. And that's exactly what's going on in Flint.
Well, it's not buyer beware. And remember,
it's the government that handles the water in Flint.
You got that backwards.
Somehow or another, Flint, Michigan's drinking water gets blamed on libertarians when it's government drinking water, right?
No, it's blamed on because people are now getting $200 and $1,000 bills for their drinking water in Flint. I heard a report the other day. A woman opened up her bill, and she's getting $1,000 for poisoned drinking water. And that's marketplace.
No, sir. That is the government.
No, it's not. That's not marketplace. That's the most ridiculous statement.
I don't know what you...
Would you call Snyder a libertarian, or would you call him a Tea Party type, or... The governor up there.
I'd call him
a Republican. Republicans are not libertarians.
I think you're very confused.
This is part of the problem with Rand Paul is he's gotten out there and confused people into thinking that Republicans are libertarians. They're not.
Right.
And they're not at all. Whoever the hell this guy is in Michigan, he's no libertarian. There are no libertarian governors in the United States. The government, even if it were run by libertarians, is still not the marketplace. It's still a monopoly on violence. And when the government provides bad water to people, you don't get to blame that on the marketplace.
Right. You can only blame the water.
Yeah, you do.
No, you don't.
Because the marketplace poisoned it.
No, it didn't. The government is in charge of sourcing and delivering the water.
No, you mean for General Motors to have started poisoning that river.
Hold on, that river is just fine. You go research the Flint River. It was an additive added to the water by the government that caused the pipes that were made of old iron pipes to leach out the leach out and then cause the problems.
No, they didn't put the additive in.
No, it was the additive.
That's also going by the
assumption that NPR disagrees with you. How's that?
Well, you're not even keeping up with the sciences because, first of all, General Motors just a few months ago was complaining to the manager of Flint. In other words, Governor Snyder came in, outlawed a whole bunch of mayors, and he outlawed the city government of Flint, and he put in a special executive manager. The special executive manager.
Hold on, before you go on, you got to tell the story like the right way it actually happened. Flint is a failed city like Detroit. Right. They bring in these emergency managers when cities go bankrupt, and that, as I understand it, is what happened in Flint. So
the government messed up, so the government picked up for the government, and then the government installed a government inspector who then added, changed the water source and then added an additive to make sure that everything was fine, and the government pipes that deliver the government water then, were poisoned and ugly, and it's the libertarians and the free market's fault.
Look, and in addition to that, even if this, I don't know anything about the river and what you're saying
actually,
was clean, Mark, but even if it wasn't.
Right, he is right about the additive, though. You do have that backwards. They didn't add an additive because they were afraid of bacteria. They were afraid that the bacteria would feed on the additive, and so they didn't add anti-corrosive measures to the water.
But wait.
No, it was the...
Even if the river is polluted by GM, you've got to remember, the river is not private property. The river is government property,
right.
And it's frequently the case that government will allow their corporate buddies to pollute government property. And so even if the river was polluted, you still have the government making the decision to use a polluted river as a water source. David, thanks for the call tonight.
Cronyism.
I appreciate it.
Cronyism.
But it's the government. Thanks
the only
the
way
call.
You get cronyism is when the government can hand out its favors.
Right. If you've got a marketplace, then private property is owned by the actors in the market, and then there will be mistakes in the marketplace. Companies will screw things up. There's no doubt about that. But ultimately, you're never forced to pay for the mistakes of a company. When Walmart botches up some new whatever it is, product or service or delivery or whatever, you don't have to pay for it. You can shop somewhere else. But with the government, if you don't like it, too bad. You have to keep paying for it. And he asked the question of how the government went bankrupt. I don't know if you heard him say that, but David for a moment there did say, when I said that Flint had gone bankrupt, how does that happen? Well, it's a government. Governments spend more in a lot of cases than they bring in. And what you saw happen, at least with Detroit, I'm more familiar with Detroit, so I can tell you, what happened there, and I suspect Flint was very similar. But with Detroit, there was this boom, this economic boom. Then there was the bust, the bubble burst when it came to the real estate bubble. All these properties went down in value dramatically. The government was used to spending the money that they were getting in during the heyday. And then all of a sudden, they couldn't collect the same amount. But the government doesn't want to cut back its government services. It doesn't want to cut back on the employees that it has. And, if you're bringing in less than you're spending, that's a problem. It's Free Talk Live.
Pop quiz for all business owners. If you're not incorporated and someone sues your business, which one of these can you lose? Your home, your car, or your life savings? The answer? All three. Because if you're not incorporated, it's not just your business that can be sued, it's you too, which means you could lose everything. Once business owners realize the risk of not being incorporated, they usually scramble to incorporate or form an LLC. To make it quick and easy, Incorporate.com is now giving away a free incorporation guide to all business owners, so you can incorporate in just 10 minutes. For your free 10-minute incorporation guide, call now, 1-800-915-1027. Protect your financial future. At Incorporate.com, they don't provide legal or financial advice. They just make incorporating or forming an LLC quick and easy. Call now for your free 10-minute incorporation guide, 1-800-915-1027. Hurry while supplies last. 1-800-915-1027. That's 1-800-915-1027.
Dr. Joe Wallach is not your typical doctor. Both a veterinarian and naturopathic physician, Dr. Wallach asked, why does America spend more money on healthcare by far and yet ranks 50th in health and longevity worldwide? The doctor believes that people should be empowered with a basic understanding of nutrition, then take charge of their life to attain optimal health and longevity through nutrition, not by toxic prescription drugs that lead to side effects, requiring more toxic prescription drugs. Talk about being dependent on drug companies, to our own destruction, no less. This is clearly a deadly recipe. Doc Wallach's message is resonating with an increasing number of Americans who are waking up to all the government and big pharma manipulation of our healthcare system. I like what Doc Wallach is saying and doing to enlighten people and have joined forces to help this tireless crusader spread his message. Visit GCNminerals.com and listen to Dr. Wallach's Deadly Recipes lecture. It makes a lot of sense, and I invite you to join the GCN Minerals team. Go to GCNminerals.com. That's GCNminerals.com.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
LRN.fm is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for LRN.fm in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate us 5 stars, then share the link on your social media and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.fm. Download it now, free, at apps.lrn.fm.
Have you felt different almost your entire life? Like the way things are run never made any sense? They've tried to get you to believe that you couldn't handle making all of your own decisions. That your lives had to be governed by a set of rules based on punishing everyone for the mistakes of a few. It's been a long journey, but the Free State Project has finally met its goal of 20,000 participants. Early movers have already accomplished so much, but we still need your help to show the world we can build a shining beacon of liberty. Stop making excuses and join us here in New Hampshire. Visit freestateproject.org.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. Dial in toll-free here to join us at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We had a gentleman on the line here a moment ago bringing up the issue of the Flint water disaster, and we're going to get further into that here because, Mark, you've been doing some digging, and I actually happen to have a related story as well. So we can come back and talk more about the government here if you want, but in this case, or like the national government, in this case, this is a local tragedy, people being poisoned by their own government. And our caller, David, was blaming it on the marketplace. He was blaming...
This happens a lot. I mean, my name has been tagged in so many of these Flint, Michigan water things. It's like, how do you explain this? The libertarians explain this. And well, government water sucks.
And I had said that Mark was right over, or that the caller was right over Mark, and it turns out that that's not true. Mark was right, and the caller was right.
All right, what was the clarification that needed to be made about this?
Well, so first off, there was an additive that was added that caused the corrosion. So there is
chlorine.
It's a chlorine byproduct.
Was this after they went to the new water source? So they went to this new water source.
They go to the Flint River, which for all intents and purposes appears to be a pretty good place to get water.
Okay.
But they had to do some additives. And so let me listen to this. On August the 21st, 2014, tests showed the city's water tested high for THMs. That's a chlorine byproduct linked to cancer and other diseases with long-term exposure and formed as a byproduct of disinfecting water. The THM testing on November 20th, a few months later, showed only one location out of eight with unsafe levels. Based on the August test, the city was placed in violation notice by the DEQ and mailed on January the 2nd, 2015, the requisite notice to the city residents. Additional chlorine was added to eliminate the bacteria detected in August and September, which was likely the cause for the spike in THMs. So that was the adding here. So
they added something to control bacteria that created something that was also bad.
Right. So in January 2015, a local meeting was held where citizens complained about the bad water. Residents complained about the taste, the smell, the appearance of the water for 18 months before a Flint physician found highly elevated blood levels in children, blood lead levels of children in Flint, Michigan. Well, the Michigan Department of Environmental Quality insisted the water was safe to drink.
Right.
This brown stuff.
Basically, the high chlorine levels were causing the lead pipes to corrode into the water.
That's right.
So that the lead was leaching into people's bodies. And lead is a neurotoxin. I mean, it just makes you stupid. And
that's why they don't want kids to eat paint chips with lead.
Doesn't exist. I mean, they're...
It still exists.
It's pre-1978. It's anything
some walls still have lead paint on
them. Yeah, for sure.
Right.
And some, there's like asbestos tiles still in houses and other things. It's just, there's some horrible things still lurking in
asbestos
old construction.
On this house.
Old construction. So they were afraid, though, that, the chlorination kills the bacteria, but then this corrosion started because of the chlorination. So then they were thinking they might add an anti-corrosive agent to the water to prevent the pipes from leaching more lead. But then they were afraid because the anti-corrosive agent can spawn more bacterial growth, which would undo the chlorination that they did. So they didn't add an anti-corrosive agent to the water. So, I mean, it's on both sides. Not only did they add something that caused the problem, but they also didn't add something that caused the problem as well.
And the thing here, so people want to blame this on libertarians, and that's just dumb. Okay, so I say there should be a free market in water, and I'm not entirely sure how the free market in water would look. But while we have government water and the government messes up in delivering you government water, you can't blame me and you can't blame the free market.
Yeah.
What you can say here is that in order to fix problems, you got to try new things. And in this case, and sometimes new things are going to fail. In this case, the new things failed. So, I mean, I think this could have happened if it was a free market system, if it was a government system, if the Democrats were in control, if the Republicans were in control. I don't think that this is just an issue where they tried something new and they failed trying something new.
But the difference being, I think the difference between the marketplace and the failure of the state is that in the market, there's a greater incentive to get it right, even though sometimes companies fail and they get things wrong. The incentive to get it right is that there are competitors in the marketplace who will take your market share if you fail. So you're more likely to want to test the water more often and, be more responsive to customer complaints, because government doesn't have to be responsive to customer complaints. When government gets a complaint, it's like, oh, what are you going to do? We are the government. You got to use our services.
There's always going to be mistakes, and this was a mistake. And I mean, you don't see a lot of government.
Didn't it go on for a long time and they tried to cover it up? I believe they did, right?
No, there were different problems all along. Mm-hmm. So looking back, it looks like this was stupid.
They didn't try to cover it up?
You took the worst, dirtiest river in America and pumped it out through
You're saying they didn't try
to
cover this up?
To poor people.
They didn't try to cover this up?
Well,
they didn't point fingers at one another.
Did Toyota try to cover up its foible from a couple of years ago? Big organizations, any organization, covers up its mistakes. This is all I'm saying, Ian. All I'm saying is that this was some people trying something new, and it failed. I don't think that you can say.
But are you trying to tell me the government has the same incentive to keep their S straight as the marketplace?
In this circumstance, this failure is as catastrophic to the people who made the failure as any failure that any company could have made. This is terrible, and it's coming out mostly against the Republicans. So, yes, the Republicans do have an incentive not to have something this catastrophic occur. I imagine that they don't have that happen very often, but they don't make a lot of changes.
There's Democrats on the Flint City Council, so this is a government problem, not a Republican-Democrat problem.
Decision-making was taken away from the Democrats in this circumstance. The Democrats have a pretty good position to sort of wash their hand and say, look how dumb those Republicans are. Mm. Now, you can point – there's plenty of things. All you have to do is point at Flint, Michigan and say, look how dumb the Democrats are, right? But when it comes to the water specifically, the Republicans kind of have to wear this one.
Well, this is a government problem to me.
Yeah, agreed.
Yeah, I think it's a distraction to make it a Republican versus Democrat issue because –
that's how that works, though. That's what they do.
Yeah, but that's not – but, you know, the idea that the Democrats wouldn't have botched this one up had they been in charge, I'm sorry. I don't believe that one either. The incentives are the same, whichever the political party is. And the fact is the government doesn't have the same incentives. I'm agreeing with you, Mark, that the marketplace can screw things up. But ultimately, the marketplace has better checks inside it because of competition than the government does. The government doesn't have that.
Well, I mean, in this case, is in the case where this happened in Flint, the case where it happened in D.C., the EPA knew about it for years in advance. So to say that this isn't government caused is utterly ridiculous because the EPA was like, yeah, the lead levels are going up in all the children to really dangerous amounts. It's from the water supply and don't tell anybody.
Hold on. The EPA knew about this for how many years?
Like three.
How it wasn't going on for three
in
years.
D.C.
In D.C.
In the D.C. or a thing. I don't know about
Was there a D.C. water nightmare too?
I don't know anything about the
sure
D.C.
Sure is.
Well, you can share your thoughts here. Maybe you're in Michigan. You've been paying close attention to the story. You've got the chance to dial in toll-free, 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. Headline at the Washington Post, hope and clean water remains elusive for the people of Flint. Because the water is only one of the problems in Flint, Michigan. It's Free Talk Live.
Hunters, anglers, campers, and survivalists. Get back to nature. Expand your horizons with the highest quality, most versatile, unique slingshots and slingbows on the market at slingbow.com. Slingbow products are compact and models start from just $17.98. They're perfect for your bug out bag or storing in your vehicle. Give yourself and your loved ones the excitement and tradition of slingbow. A new frontier in archery and truly modern twist on this primitive survival tool. Feel the thrill only at slingbow.com. So you've got to take a state construction license exam or certification. Can't decide on what books or what chapters to study? Discover right now how you can eliminate unnecessary books and wasted study time. At contractorexam.com, our study materials zero in on state-required test topics in an effective, multiple-choice format. So whether you're a plumber, electrician, general contractor, or other construction-related trade, contractorexam.com will help get you prepared. Visit us at www.contractorexam.com today.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on join the Free State Project and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. When you amp Free Talk Live, you get perks like access to the AMP only Facebook group and AMP podcast. Visit amp.freetalklive.com.
This is your Robertson Roberts Brokerage Daily Precious Metals Update. On Tuesday, gold is $2 higher at $1,192 per ounce. Silver is up 4 cents at $15.39 per ounce. Bitcoin is trading at $375. We're offering up to 200 Gold American Eagle 10th ounce coins for $60 off the usual ounce price each. Call us and ask about this special at 800-874-9760 or visit us online at rrbi.co.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com. Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to saveitpurse.com and open an account. Do this right now. Don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. I know this sounds unbelievable, but at my house, we saved as much as 45% off of a new item on Amazon. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to saveitpurse.com right now, get signed up, and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 15 to 25% off of everything at Amazon through saveitpurse.com. It's saveatpurse.com.
Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. You can dial toll-free here to join us at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We hadn't planned on talking about Flint and their water disaster, but that's where we are now because that's what you can do here on Free Talk Live. You can bring up anything you want on our toll-free lines. Also, Skype username lrn.fm. Joining you in studio, Ian here.
And Johnson.
And Mark.
Don't forget to join us online at freetalklive.com. And then join us in real life at the Liberty Forum coming up in less than 2 weeks. It's going to be here before you know it. It's happening in Manchester at the Radisson Hotel in New Hampshire. It's a beautiful hotel. It's very, very nice. Great place for a convention. In fact, the largest convention space in all of New Hampshire, as far as I know. And you can join us from February 18th through the 21st. So, again, starting in just about 2 weeks, actually less than that, like a week and a half at this point. NHLibertyForum.com. You can go and get registered for the event there. It's very affordable. It's, I think, $125 for a basic ticket, which gets you in for the entire weekend. And this is an extended weekend. It's February 18th. That's a Thursday through Sunday, the 21st. So come on up as early as you can for this, because on Thursday, it's going to be a lot of fun. There's going to be a group traveling up to the State House for a tour. And on this tour, you will meet some state representatives who are liberty-oriented, and you will learn all of the ins and outs of what it's like to get active within the political system here in New Hampshire.
I can't remember where the article's from, but I just saw one today, and it said New Hampshire, where anybody can get elected as
That's a state rep. Yeah, it can happen here. And in fact, many free staters have been elected. And this is basically your chance to come up and check out the Free State Project, one of your chances, because there's always the Porcupine Freedom Festival in the summer and Keenvention in the fall. But this is a great excuse to come up right here in the wintertime, and it's an excellent hotel convention. We've been every single year. We were there at the very first Liberty Forum broadcasting live, and Free Talk Live will again be broadcasting live every single night from the Liberty Forum. So we'll look forward to seeing you, and you'll get to see Edward Snowden speaking the keynote speech at Liberty Forum. So that's very exciting. A lot of other great speakers as well, including Lynn Ulbricht, the mother of Ross Ulbricht, the creator of the Silk Road Underground Drug Marketplace. She'll be there again this year speaking as well. So very exciting times. And of course, it'll be in celebration. The whole event is going to be in celebration of the Free State Project completing its goal of 20,000 liberty-loving people, people like you and I who care about freedom, who've signed up for the Free State Project and who are now planning to make their move. They've got 5 years to do it, and this is the first Liberty Forum since the completion of the Free State Project. So I believe the atmosphere will be very, very jovial and lots of fun. I'll look forward to seeing you there. NHLibertyForum.com, February 18th through the 21st.
I've come to a great point here in an article about how exactly the government is responsible.
Is this the one at Huffington Post?
It is. Yep.
Tell me about it.
I've been like trying to skim and read
through. It's a huge article.
It is.
Well, it's a really complicated issue, and that's why, you know, just trying to lay it out that, you know, this group of people or that group of people are responsible is just not that easy.
I found a good point where I'm satisfied, and it's like three quarters of the way through the article, so I'd like to just start reading from here.
Do it.
And see. The city and state governments resisted tackling Flint's problem last year, even in the face of several bright red flags. In June, more than a year after the city had begun using the Flint River as its water source, an EPA official named Miguel de Toral wrote up the preliminary results of his investigation into reports of high lead levels. The memo lamented the Michigan Department of Environmental Quality's failure to make sure that the river was treated so that it wouldn't corrode the city's pipes, many of which contained lead. De Terrell explained that federal rules require systems of Flint size to control for corrosion. A major concern from public health standpoint is the absence of corrosion control treatment in the city of Flint for mitigating lead and copper levels in the drinking water, De Terrell wrote. Recent drinking water sample results indicate the presence of high lead results in the drinking water, which is to be expected in a public water system that is not providing corrosion control treatment. The lack of any mitigating treatment for lead is a serious concern for residents that live in homes with lead service lines or partial lead service lines, which are common throughout the city of Flint.
They're common in a lot of cities. Yep.
That memo wasn't supposed to be released, but Kurt Guyette, a reporter for the American Civil Liberties Union of Michigan, obtained a copy from Leanne Walters, a Flint resident who had been given a copy by De Terrell after he took water samples from her house.
So the federal EPA agent sent the state, basically, and Flint this memo saying, hey, you guys, you know, you're botching this up. But they weren't, originally they were not going to release it.
Oh, so yeah, they were trying to keep it a secret.
It was leaked out. Again, this is leaked. The cover-up I was talking about.
Yep. So she'd contacted the EPA because she was worried about her water and her kids. City and state officials downplayed De Terrell's report, and the EPA said that it was only a draft and that it wasn't supposed to be released. Hmm. Brad Werfel, a spokesman for the Michigan Department of Environmental Quality, told a local reporter in July that anyone who is concerned about lead in the drinking water in Flint can relax. In August, government officials met with Flint residents, including Walters, and told them that De Terrell had been handled and that his report wouldn't be finalized. Edwards, the Virginia Tech professor who had been watching the Flint water situation since Walters had sought him out for additional tests on her water, which Edwards' analysis revealed to have toxic waste levels of lead, when he heard about the meeting and the dismissive tone that officials took with Walters, he got mad. I was shaking with anger because to brag, smirk, and laugh at a mother with lead-poisoned kids, what kind of people do that? Edwards said.
People with no responsibility for their actions.
Yep. He says, frankly, they're just evil, horrible people. His experience battling various levels of government over Washington's water crisis had left him so jaded that he almost sounds like a conspiracy theorist. In D.C.
Well, it is a conspiracy. Yeah. That's the thing about these is that, you know, once there's a problem, and there's always, I mean, that's what happens when you have a big organization like this. It's problem management. Right. Well, this is a really big problem, and what are you supposed to do? Are you supposed to tell everybody, hey, it looks like it's a disaster? Well, you're not exactly sure yet, and that kind of thing.
Mm-hmm. So this guy Edwards goes on to say, he says, in D.C., I learned that you can't trust your kids with a government agency. After Michigan state officials downplayed
who doesn't know that?
After Michigan state officials downplayed De Terrell's report, Edwards assembled a team of his Virginia Tech colleagues and students to independently test Flint's water, marshaling the help of activists and volunteers there to collect samples. When state officials said that they doubted his preliminary results, which showed high lead levels, Edwards
in trouble. You've got the state sort of. They have the presumed monopoly over testing water, but now they've got an independent in there who's doing his own tests on the water, and he's like a college professor, so it's going to be hard for them to say, well, this guy, this expert, doesn't really know what he's talking about. We're the state. You should only listen to us.
Well, and so what he did is he said, Freedom of Information Act, give me your data. So he filed freedom of information or FOIA requests for Michigan's own data and official correspondence related to the government's response. Edwards' team also created a website, flintwaterstudy.org, where they publicly posted everything they found, a strategy inspired by D.C. water safety activist Yana Lambrinidou, who had run a similar website in Washington. Once we saw the lead in the water was high, we started directly working with the ACLU and the activist groups in Flint, which is kind of something you don't do because people will say you're an activist, Edwards said. But what I learned in D.C. is that science alone is powerless, absolutely powerless to these agencies. Facts mean nothing to these people. Scientific truth means nothing to them. The emails uncovered through Edwards' record requests revealed bumbling by the state government, but also to the degree to which the EPA helped the state and local leaders try to allay public concerns. Susan Hedman, the
sounds like quite the conspiracy.
So a conspiracy on both the city, the
and
state, and the federal level.
Yeah. Susan Hedman, the administrator of the regional EPA office, told then Mayor Dane Walling in a July email that Del Torre's preliminary draft report should not have been released outside the agency, something that Hedman reiterated in several other messages. During his unsuccessful re-election campaign, Walling told voters that Del Torre's report didn't reflect the opinion of the entire agency. Hedman just buried the thing, Edwards said.
Well, if it doesn't, I mean, that's the problem is that you send your guy out there and he says that everything's fine, and then you're later saying, well, that was not everybody's opinion in the agency. Well,
the guy didn't say everything's fine. He said this is crazy messed up. That was what his report said, and that's what they were trying to brush under the rug. The toll-free number here, if you got more highlights, Johnson, we can share those, and the toll-free number allows you to join us as well at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. This is Free Talk Live.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to saveitpurse.com and open an account. Do this right now. Don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to saveitpurse.com right now, get signed up, and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 15 to 25% off of everything at Amazon through saveitpurse.com. It's saveitpurse.com.
Average weight lost in a study was 8.3 pounds and 4.2 inches total in first month. Results vary. Call to cancel within 14 days and return remaining non-frozen food for a refund, less return shipping. Free shakes with first order only.
All right, guys. The holidays are over and we have got some weight to lose. Let's do this. It's going to take pizza, some pasta, some chicken parm. Great foods. All part of the awesome new Turbo 10 program from Nutrisystem. You'll love it. Money back guaranteed. Lose up to 10 pounds and 5 inches in your first month. Look, you keep putting it off, you'll keep putting it on. So call Nutrisystem today and get 4 weeks of delicious meals and 1 week of Nutrisystem's new Turbo Shakes free. Packed with protein plus probiotics to help support digestive health and bust that gut. You'll also get a week of Nutra Crush Shakes to crush hunger free. Come on, lose up to 10 pounds and 5 inches in your first month. Call 866-987-THIN. 866-987-THIN. Make the call. 866-987-THIN.
Money, power, and respect are all yours at CreditSuccessSecretsRevealed.com. Be seen as an industry leader. You can do it. The last application you filled out when it was time to hit submit, did your nerves spike? You didn't get the approval you seek, but there's a better way. We teach you exactly what to place into the right systems the right way the first time so you get approved. Get up to $100,000 in instant business credit. Many people will get cash on the spot. Use those two tools in your new corporate credit engine so you can walk into the bank and get your project funded today. It's all about today at CreditSuccessSecretsRevealed.com. Credit Success Secrets Revealed is explosive and ignites instant results. Dial 1-800-707-8719. That's 1-800-707-8719. 1-800-707-8719. Or just go to CreditSuccessSecretsRevealed.com.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
Free speech is protected on the internet, right? Not always. Government agencies try to limit free speech and commerce on the net. Luckily, when they do, the Institute for Justice is there to defend your First Amendment right to free speech. IJ helped set the first federal precedent for internet free speech in 1999, and ever since has worked to prevent unconstitutional roadblocks in cyberspace. Visit our website today at ij.org.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. Join us right here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You know, another thing about the difference between being a government agency versus a private company and the level of responsibility that one has, we were talking about, you know, could this have happened in the market, the screw-up of the Flint size, you know, that issue of the water supply there. Could that have happened? Yes, companies can make mistakes, but their incentives to be better performing are much higher than governments. One of the things that is a disincentive to government performance is the fact that many government employees cannot be held responsible legally for their actions. So when a government manager botches up a water supply and poisons people, you know, through their either their inaction or their action or whatever, they probably will be found that they have qualified immunity from any kind of consequences for their actions. And the worst case scenario for them is that they have to resign and hang their head in shame, that they're not actually held to any kind of account for what they've done. Yeah, and another example of this sort of crossover, the cronyism that was being talked about by our caller before, look at the BP oil spill. BP, that was a, you know, definitely a screw-up of mega proportions by a private company. But they weren't required to foot the bill for it. It was the taxpayer. It was, I believe the cap was $75 million. So the, as far as the cleanup was concerned, right, the Gulf of Mexico, there was a $75 million cap, which is nothing. I mean, if you think about $75 million as far as BP, you know, they've got that in their back pocket.
Right.
But once they hit that $75 million cap, that's when the federal government, I believe, was the one that then took care of the rest of the cost. So it was the taxpayers who were on the hook because of that. So again, there's the government giving an easy out for this private company that otherwise would have been able to be held liable had they polluted, let's say, private property. If they'd polluted a private ocean or something like that, or ocean that had, you know, private owners, I don't know how you do that, but the marketplace could come up with a way to do that. But nonetheless, you know, these are examples of government-created tragedies.
It wouldn't be too difficult for, you know, different fishing agencies or, you know, whatever, organizations to
homestead
the ocean and that sort of thing.
Here's a little more from the story that you had, Johnson, from Huffington Post about you know, how it is that the federal government and the state government and the local government basically all kind of work together to cover this up. In the story here, in late September, Dr. Hannah Atisha released her findings documenting a spike in blood lead levels among Flint's kids that corresponded with the city's water switch. The county government issued a lead advisory, and in October, the Michigan Department of Environmental Quality admitted that it had failed to follow the federal rules for corrosion control soon after Flint switched back to Detroit's water system, though it's unclear how soon the lead levels will fall. Huffington Post asked one of the EPA bureaucrats why it took outside pressure to force a change, and she said, quote, "An informed public that calls on government to take action is an important force for protection of the environment and public health." But another one of the activists put it more strongly, "The poisoning of an entire population was entirely preventable." at the end of the year, the Department of Environmental Water Quality Director and a few others resigned. Governor Snyder at the time said, "I want the Flint community to know how very sorry I am that this has happened." Of course, you know, he wasn't the one who made the ultimate decisions.
Right.
But nonetheless, he gets it's to be sorry for
his
it.
His head that has to go on the platter.
Several Flint residents have sued over the harm to their health. But if what happened to Washington residents is any guide, they won't get swift justice. Several D.C. parents went to court asking for compensation for injuries to their children, allegedly caused by lead poisoning. The courts wouldn't let a class action case proceed, and now just a handful of families expect to go to trial this year. One of the plaintiffs, a father of two boys, alleges that the D.C. Water and Sewer Authority knew of the high lead levels in 2001. So this was 2001 when they supposedly knew about it, and here we are in 2016, and it's just now going to trial.
Justice's terrible swift sword.
In 2007, worried about his son's behavioral and learning difficulties, apparently D.C. did nothing to warn people, Parkhurst then took them to a doctor for neurophysical evaluation, which identified learning and attention problems. The cost of medication and therapy for the boys eventually totaled as much as $75,000, said the suit, and the boys also faced, quote, diminished earning capacity because of the intellectual impairments that they have suffered, unquote. Washington has kept its lead levels below the EPA's required action level since 2005, and apparently they are now historically low, despite scientific evidence that at a minimum hundreds of children suffered the elevated blood lead levels in the early 2000s. D.C. Water Chief George Hawkins told Huffington Post that it is not clear to him that anyone has been harmed by the once toxic water. So here you are with a bureaucrat saying,
yeah. What? Cigarettes don't cause cancer?
Yeah. This man, George Hawkins, the D.C. water chief, said, quote, "In most of the lead cases we worried about in the city, you almost always track it down to lead paint or something of a much greater concentration. I think the jury is still out."
Of course they do.
And you have to wonder.
That's because they're at fault.
The paint is just sloughing off the houses for no particular reason.
Well, he can't admit, right? Like, he can't admit, yes, you know, it was our fault, because that could put them up to some level of liability. And further, what you might end up seeing with these court cases is that they might get kicked out for lack of standing or lack, you know, failure to state a claim on which relief can be granted.
Don't you agree that sort of that the local municipal delivery of water is one of the most difficult things for libertarians to sort of address?
It's, you know, hard.
The free market delivery of water and what that would look like. Would every house have to have its own cistern? Would a truck, you know, have to use fossil fuels in order to deliver water to your house and pump it up to the thing on top of your roof so that you can then get the water? Does everybody basically have their own water tower?
I don't know.
Are there local, you know, like small level, community level wells that are drilled and everybody gets their water from that? I mean, it's really difficult to know exactly what this would look like.
Has there been much, you know, intellectual thought put into that? I mean, I know there have been books written about like privatizing or marketing the roads.
Everything but this. I don't know the answer is. I'm sure one of our listeners will send me a link later on this evening of somebody who's probably put some thought into this more so than I have. But I would like to say that if you think about America's rural population, the water at my house is delivered by the free market.
Got a well.
Yeah, I've got a well. We've dug, I've got three of them. Mm-hmm. We got a couple of dug wells, and we have one artesian well, which means that they've drilled down to the aquifer. But every once in a while, you'll hear some scientist saying, you know, we got a problem with the amount of water in the aquifer. People are depleting it and that kind of thing. Mm-hmm. So, you know, at some point, if enough people are on the aquifer, then that water's gone too.
Right. What do you
do about that? So many times when you're dealing with municipalities, they're getting their water from a source, like a lake, mm-hmm, or a river, and they're treating it and then giving river water to the populace.
It's going
to
be
pipes.
A non-issue. The whole water thing in a few years is going to be a complete non-issue because they've recently developed a nanomaterial with new nanoparticle sciences. They've developed a nanomaterial that is a filter that can desalinate water. Oh. So this is like something that's brand new.
Okay.
You just pour water in, pour ocean water into it. It removes everything, and now you've got pure drinking water. That simple. No more osmosis. No more. You know,
well, you still got to move the water from the ocean to.
That's
wherever
pretty
it's going.
Easy. You know, comparatively, that's pretty simple. And if it's a filter like this, that could be as simple as putting this filter in the top of a bottle, going down and scooping it out of the ocean, and there you go.
So I think one of the big objections, and it's a legitimate one, is, okay, you guys, you want to have the market take over the water. Well, what happens when, you know, some private company is now running the government's water system and they jack the rates up?
Well, if you're basically, you know, when it comes to pipes, when you're dealing with, you know, any organization that's going to deliver water in the way that we're used to through pipes, yep. You're dealing with a monopoly, right? Because you don't even own the pipes that go beyond your yard.
Right.
And you're dealing with a monopoly now. And the city is a monopoly.
Right, and it would be cost prohibitive for another company. Likely, it would be cost prohibitive for another company to come in and lay a second set of pipes all throughout an entire city to provide a competing water service.
Yeah, that's really redundant.
Yeah, the amount of money you'd have to outlay to dig up all the, you know, dig up every road in the city and then lay new pipes in there. Just no one's going to do that, right?
Not likely.
So how do you address that particular objection? The toll-free number tonight is 855-450-FREE. Let's go to Mike listening in Washington. You're on Free Talk Live. Go ahead, Mike.
Hey, how's it going?
Hey, you're on the radio. Go ahead with your thoughts.
Yeah, so I just wanted to comment about the privatized water.
Yes,
there's actually devices that will pull moisture out of the air and then produce water. Just by running essentially a compressor and
dehumidifiers.
The way that it works, it's like a dehumidifier, yeah. And except, you know, very, very task specific. But
yeah, but how much water can you really pull out of the air? I mean, is
especially
it
several
in
gallons
in Tempe? It's going to be a whole different story than...
Hold that thought, Mike. I want to hear more about what you have to say in moments. I'm not saying it's a terrible idea. I've seen these things. They're fairly expensive. That doesn't mean the cost wouldn't come down with competition, though. It's Free Talk Live.
Currency is too important a thing to be left in the hands of government bureaucrats, especially when billions of dollars can be created with the swipe of a pen. Overstock.com supports the cryptocurrency movement because it returns the power of an inflation-proof money to the people where it belongs. Did you know that you can use Bitcoin to pay for anything Overstock.com sells while enjoying free shipping on orders of 0.211 Bitcoin or more? If you support freedom in the cryptocurrency movement, you should support Overstock.com.
You can control your health care with Liberty HealthShare.
Liberty HealthShare is like-minded people coming together to share medical costs, which saves money.
You don't even have to pay for procedures that violate your conscience.
Because we all share the same values.
Join the movement of people who share in medical costs and change the way you pay for your health care forever.
Go to libertyhealthshare.org to find out more.
Liberty HealthShare.
Together, we're changing health care for good. libertyhealthshare.org.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, mark@freetalklive.com. Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. facebook.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Tuesday, February 9th, 2016. Silver is trading at $15.34 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,197 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $376. Antiwar.com reports fulfilling a campaign pledge to end his nation's involvement, Canadian Prime Minister Justin Trudeau has announced that all Canadian airstrikes against the Islamic State in Iraq and Syria will end by February 22nd at the latest. Trudeau campaigned heavily last year on his promise to end Canadian airstrikes, a position that grew in popularity amid reports that the Canadian Defense Ministry had covered up allegations of civilians killed in the airstrikes. Among the Canadian airstrikes, the deadliest to be made public was an attack against a dairy, which Canadian officials claimed was a weapons factory. That strike killed 10 civilian workers and wounded 20 others. Though the U.S. was seen as annoyed at Canada ending its airstrikes, the Pentagon on Monday ignored the report and instead announced that Canada had promised to triple the number of ground troops they are committing to northern Iraq. At present, Canada has up to 70 ground troops in Iraq, so the tripling will mean at most another 140 Canadian troops. Canadian trainers have been involved in some high-profile clashes with the Islamic State troops in the past, though are believed to have been moved back away from the frontier since then. For nearly 40 years, Roberts & Roberts Brokerage has been a trusted source for buying and selling precious metals like gold and silver. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and have permanently removed the minimum purchase amount for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on buying and selling precious metals and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 800-874-9760 or visit online at rrbi.co. UPI reports a winter storm is expected to bring 3 to 8 inches of snow throughout most of Massachusetts, as neighboring New Hampshire could see some snow ahead of presidential primaries. Blizzard conditions are expected in Cape Cod, southeastern Massachusetts, and its islands. Many schools in the state, including those in Boston, Cambridge, Arlington, Chelsea, Salem, and Barnstable, were not open on Monday. Massachusetts Governor Charlie Baker closed state offices in eastern Massachusetts for non-emergency personnel in anticipation of the storm. Some cities in Massachusetts introduced parking bans on Monday. In Boston, where between 8 to 12 inches of snow is expected, the snow began falling between 4 and 6 a.m., and the heaviest snowfall is predicted between 7 a.m. and 2 p.m. At least two flights have been canceled from Boston's Logan International Airport. In New Hampshire, where presidential primaries are scheduled for Tuesday, a snowstorm recently brought up to 10 inches of snow in some areas. A winter weather advisory is active throughout the state, with the possibility of light snowfall throughout much of New Hampshire on Tuesday. There is a 20% chance of precipitation on Tuesday in Manchester, the state's largest city, and a temperature of 29 degrees. In Woodstock, there's a 20% chance of snow and a 30-degree high. The Daily Decrypt is a Monday through Friday newscast about all the best news in cryptocurrencies and peer-to-peer networks. Know what's hot in the world of digital money, borderless trade, and cutting-edge communications. Available on YouTube, SoundCloud, and Facebook Video. The Daily Decrypt is the news of the future. Reuters reports a U.S. federal judge denied for the second time a request by Texas to bar relief agencies from bringing Syrian refugees into the state, a decision that could have a bearing on the attempt of 30 other governors to block refugees from their states. U.S. District Judge David Godbee said the Republican leaders who have fought the resettlement have not shown Texas would suffer irreparable harm. The same judge rejected in December the state's request for a restraining order, saying the evidence presented was largely speculative hearsay. Godbee wrote in the decision, "The court does not deny that Syrian refugees pose some risk. That would be foolish. In our country, however, it is the federal executive that is charged with assessing and mitigating that risk, not the states and not the courts." President Obama has pledged to take in 10,000 people fleeing war-torn Syria and has so far admitted 2,000 refugees. Europe is dealing with millions of refugees fleeing conflict in the Middle East and Africa. Since fiscal year 2011, 243 Syrian refugees have resettled in Texas, making the state one of the main U.S. relocation sites since the Syrian civil war erupted about 5 years ago. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
California is reeling from Super Rainbow Percival, which left a trail of devastation along the West Coast. A luminous band of destruction touched down in Santa Barbara. Percival set a record as the most powerful rainbow in U.S. history, with at least 30 confirmed fatalities and damage estimates in the billions. The vividly saturated colors seared through homes and roads, charring everything in its path. Those exposed to the rainbow's fury say they're lucky to be alive.
The sky was completely blue. All of a sudden, it's filled with brilliant hues of red and indigo.
All I can say is when I was a kid, rainbows didn't cut people in half.
Meteorologists say that Percival is just the latest in a pattern of increasingly dangerous rainbows, and that they're only growing stronger as global temperatures rise. Percival also comes on the heels of some extreme weather phenomena overseas. Authorities in the Philippines are still searching for thousands in the aftermath of mega sunset Wilma.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. We're launching into the third hour of the program. You can join us on the radio. Here, the toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. The Associated Press is now calling the race after 27% reporting the presidential primary here in New Hampshire tonight. Bernie Sanders with 58% of the vote at 27% reporting, and Hillary Clinton at 40% of the vote in the Democratic race, Donald Trump at 34% of the vote, and second in the Republican race, John Kasich at 15, Jeb Bush at 12, Ted Cruz at 12, Marco Rubio 10, and so on. And then, by the way, my candidate, Vermin Supreme, ranking in at number 5 in the Democratic race so far here tonight. Very excited.
Behind write-in.
Yep, that's true. Yeah. Behind the total write-ins. But that's not fair. You can't count total write-ins because that's a bunch of different names. So strike that one. That still puts Vermin in number 5. So it's Martin O'Malley with zero, you know, less than a percent, and then someone named David Thistle ahead of Vermin Supreme.
There you go.
So that's your update from the election. If that develops further, we will let you know. You're still welcome to comment on it. Let's go to Mike, though, in Washington, because we've been discussing something way more important than the election, and that is water. Water, far more important to your life than politicians. Water, the most important thing, actually, arguably, to your entire body. What is it, 70% or something like that? Your body's made up of water. So putting good water into your body is a pretty important thing to do in life. And unfortunately, the people of Flint, Michigan have been unable to do that due to various different government bungling and botching and cover-ups and conspiracies at all levels of government, which has led to a larger conversation about what would the marketplace water delivery systems look like. Because it's easy, you know, we know what our system is today, and in some places it seems to work pretty fine. I mean, I think one of you made a comment against government water systems earlier, but I gotta say, all things considered, the city of Keene, where we live, they do a pretty good job with their water here. Like,
yeah, I don't have that much bad to say about it. I think
New Hampshire water is pretty good, in my experience.
It starts out pretty good, too. Yeah. It's hard to mess up something that, you know.
Have you tested it? How would you know if there was lead or whatever in your water? Like, how would you know?
Every now and then, they do have things come off the pipes, and you can see that in the water here. But that's like, you know, they'll let you know sometimes when that's going to happen or whatever.
When you're getting water out of the ground, you never know if for whatever reason there's been some kind of event underground that caused some kind of poisoning too. So, you know, people who have well water, this kind of thing can happen. But there's a lot of people in America that are still have dug wells.
Yeah. Every so often in Sarasota, I remember where they would have a report, you know, in the college, they're like, you better boil your water because there's feces in your water supply.
Let's go to Mike. Mike's in Washington. He barely had a chance to get his thoughts out a few moments ago. Go ahead, Mike. What were you trying to tell us?
Yeah, so basically I was just mentioning that there are actually devices out there, and they range in size quite drastically, which will suck water out of the atmosphere just by, you know, running electricity. And they generally will produce, I can't remember the exact numbers, but if you get like a desktop-sized one, which is about the size of a little bit larger than a coffee maker or something, I think they'll produce about 10 liters per day. And then if you get you know, like a bigger one that's about the size of an office water cooler.
Mm-hmm.
They'll produce like 20 to 30 liters a day. And then they make them as big as like a 10-foot cargo container, which produces, I don't know, hundreds of gallons per day or something. But so
are there side effects from this? During the wintertime here in New Hampshire, if you've got the oil-based heat, for instance, it dries out the air in the house. So I don't know how much more water could be sucked out of that air. I mean, you wouldn't necessarily want that. Like here, we run humidifiers in order to put more moisture into the air. So
depends on the kind of heat you have. I'll tell you the disadvantage to it. This is distilled water, right?
The atmospheric water generator?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's so basically the way that those work it's kind of the same effect as when you run an air conditioner in the summer, for
right.
example.
It's distilled
right?
water, right?
It puddles up.
By definition, I believe that is distilled water, right?
Okay. Distilled water doesn't have minerals in it. It will suck the minerals right out of your body.
Oof. That's not good.
It will bond to minerals in your body.
They probably have solved this, Mark, by putting mineral filters in these units that actually likely adds minerals. It's
probably a good idea. Yeah. Run it through a salt lick.
Yeah, you can get like a mineral pack. You know, that's spring water tastes so much better because they actually control the recipe. That's why you get a consistent flavor from all these like big bottled water companies like Nestle and Poland Springs and, you know, all that stuff, because their water tastes good because they control the recipe of minerals in the water.
Well, in this case, this is one of the ways these companies make money, right? They you know, sell you the mineral filters that you then pass the water through that costs who knows how much. You have to replace them however often. So, it's a technology. It exists. I just question whether or not it's particularly a good one.
There's a brand new leap forward in this exact technology that he's talking about. There's a new water bottle called the Fontus that was just developed recently that goes on your bike. So it's like for bikers.
Okay.
And the air, they use hydrophobic materials, like nanomaterials in this, so that when the humid air passes through this water bottle, it just fills up.
As you ride your bike around,
your water bottle just fills up.
But this is the kind of water that Mark's talking about where there's no minerals in it.
Right,
it's coming
exactly.
from the air.
Yeah, you would have to add minerals.
I don't think when you're talking about that quantity of water that it's that big of a deal.
Yeah.
I see.
Yeah, I think, in either case, even if you were to run a system like that outdoors even, I mean, there's a lot of people who have AC compressors that sit outside and pump cold air in or whatever.
Yeah, and they just drip the water into the ground.
Yeah.
Yeah, so there's a lot of ways that you could, you know, effectively extract that water without, you know, drying out the inside of your house.
So you're bringing this up as an example of decentralizing the water supply rather than having one.
It's pretty expensive, though. I mean, if you were trying to get
power constantly,
to run electricity to get your water,
not
right?
Not really. My experience is I was researching manufacturers out of China who provide these things, and most of the ones that you see in the United States are just rebranded exact same machines that I found in China.
Mm-hmm.
And the cost that I typically saw for like the office sized water cooler was roughly about $350, and the bulk
per
of the cost in
unit.
That per unit.
Yeah, but I think the question from Mark was the power that you would have to consume constantly churning this compressor to suck the water, the moisture out of the air.
And it might work really well in Florida. I don't think it's going to work really well in Arizona.
Yeah, there's going to be downsides in places like Arizona for sure, but I think the main thing is you know it's going to consume less power than running an AC unit in your house, and the reason is because you're not driving a big fan to blow air into the house, you're just running the compressor, and so it consumes like
AC is one of the biggest consumers of electricity, and you generally don't run it all year round in most places. Even in Florida, we had a couple of months off where you would keep the AC off. And so, I mean, you're talking about a pretty big chunk of your electricity. You'll be cutting your water bill off, so there's that $30 a month that you're saving there, depending on what you're paying in water. Sometimes it's 40 or something like that. So there's mitigation. I don't know if this is the solution. Obviously, if it scales up, these units are going to get cheaper, but electricity is it's not going to get cheaper with more use.
Here's something that's interesting. So this scientist who's responsible for the design of this Fontus water bottle or whatever says that this is simply water bottles designed. This is simply the condensation of humidity that is contained in the air, Retazar told Live Science. You always have a certain percentage of humidity in the air, and it doesn't matter where you are, even in the desert.
Huh.
That means that you would always be potentially able to extract that humidity from the air.
How long, I wonder, you have to ride your bike to get a full bottle?
Probably a while. I mean, it's probably going to be
in Arizona, probably a very long time.
Hey, Mike, thanks for calling, man. I appreciate you bringing that to the table tonight, and thank you again for being patient. Toll-free number here, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And also, we've got Skype, so you can join us there at Skype username lrn.fm. What other cool – and I want to see this thing. What do they cost, the Frankie's bottle? Is it like $100 for a water bottle?
I don't know. Plastic? I don't think so.
At first, but once they're out.
Yeah, then... once they're popular, and they'll definitely come down due to competition. Toll-free number again, 855-450-FREE. Water delivery absent the state. What would it look like? Well, one thing's for sure, the market would likely come up with some unique things that we haven't necessarily even thought of yet. And that's one of the things markets are good about, unlike governments. It's Free Talk Live.
Are you suffering with hearing loss? Are you sick of people constantly complaining that your TV is too loud? Are you tired of asking people to speak up? Would you like to hear more clearly, but you don't want to wear a hearing aid that makes you look old? Then you need to try Listen Clear, a life-changing breakthrough precisely designed by top audio engineers to fit your ear almost invisibly. And you can adjust Listen Clear to find the perfect way to hear everything, wherever you are, and whatever you're doing. And right now you can try Listen Clear absolutely risk-free, with free shipping. We'll even give you free batteries for life. So call now. 1-800-719-9349. Listen Clear is lightweight and completely hassle-free, and it's practically invisible. Call for your 100% risk-free home trial with free shipping and free batteries for life. For free information, call now. 1-800-719-9349. That's 1-800-719-9349. 1-800-719-9349.
It's about time something new came along for better selling and buying online. And I found it.
What now, Marge?
It's buysellmakeoffer.com.
Never heard of it.
It's a brand new company. That's why you've never heard of it. It's the newest and best way to sell any products online. I did all the research.
Sell my car?
Yes.
Our home?
Yep.
My golf bag?
Your golf clubs. All of them.
How about your purse collection hoard?
Hey, now.
You said any product.
Right. I did. We get 30 days free.
Really?
Packages starting from only $7.95. And buysellmakeoffer.com will never charge item fees, ever. Never. And this is cool. Listen to this. You can even use Skype or video to show your items.
That's cool.
Yes. All we have to do is go to the website, sign up, and then load our stuff to sell. I love this site.
Buysellmakeoffer.com.
Buysellmakeoffer.com. You got it?
Buysellmakeoffer.com.
Buysellmakeoffer.com. Better selling, better buying.
Understanding your credit score is the first step towards managing and improving it. This is Charlie Sundstrom with your Van Dyke Mortgage Minute. The most influential component of your credit score is your payment history. Almost equally as important is the amount you owe on credit accounts. Also impacting your score, but to a lesser degree, are the length of time you've utilized your credit, the number of new accounts, credit inquiries, in your various types of credit accounts. To help achieve or maintain a healthy credit score, have a system set up to assure your bills are always paid on time. Don't max out your cards. It's better to have a high credit limit with a low balance. Never close old accounts. The age of these can actually help your credit score. But don't be afraid to use your credit. You need several accounts in order to have a credit score. Just keep the corresponding payments within your means. For your mortgage pre-approval and refi needs, start by visiting VanDykeMortgage.com.
Corporate NMLS 3035. Van Dyke Mortgage is an equal housing lender. Charlie Sundstrom, NMLS 134251.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at lrn.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at lrn.fm. That's lrn.fm.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Boost Kit Essentials Nutritionally Complete Drink, providing your picky eater with essential nutrition and great taste in one drink. Visit us at kitessentials.com. To make sure your kids eat healthy, follow the 5-a-day plan. Serve 3 servings of vegetables and 2 servings of fruit daily. Remember, a serving could just mean a piece of fruit or a half cup of veggies. If your kids are picky eaters, ask a nutritionist about other sources. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
Yeah! Free Talk Live. Join us on the radio here and tell us, you know, what the future of water delivery would look like without the government's involvement. Could we have a more decentralized water system? Would there be like neighborhood wells or neighborhood water plants, and rather than this one central water authority that the government provides? Would we have more decentralized than even the neighborhood? Would it be each house with a well? But what if they all tapped out the aquifer or whatever? Like, what about getting water from thin air? That's what one caller was just telling us about. So there's different options out there, and it would be interesting to see how the marketplace would handle that.
Yeah, it's kind of interesting. The world would be completely different. So to some extent, what you've got is these weird systems where people are, you know, they're letting rainwater roll off their roofs onto the ground and then buying water from the city, coming through pipes that's going through miles and miles and miles of pipes in order to spray it all over their grass so they can be urban grass farmers. I mean, none of this stuff makes a heck of a lot of sense. Water should be particularly valuable, right? I mean, it should be a commodity. And I mean, you know, what do we need yards like this for? I mean, obviously, if you're playing soccer or something, yep, nice to have grass.
I don't know. Living in New Hampshire, I've always wanted to, I want to own a property and make my lawn out of a lichen.
Out of lichens?
Lichens.
What is that? Yeah.
It's like moss, essentially, that grows on, like, the moss.
They have
that
moss in New Hampshire?
Of course there's moss in New Hampshire.
It's like you've never hiked.
What? You have moss around your house? Like, moss is everywhere in New Hampshire.
Yeah, sure
is. Like, what?
It does best in the shade.
I'm remembering it from Florida, but I just don't remember seeing it.
Oh, you're thinking of Spanish moss.
Yeah.
Okay. Spanish moss is that stuff that hangs off the tree. No, this is like a little green fuzz that grows on everything around here.
Oh,
it's that, like, fuzz that grows mostly on rocks.
That was mold or something like that.
Well, yeah, it's kind of, I mean, it's kind of similar, actually. But no, it's not mildew, not mold. It's bigger and fluffier. It almost looks like the caterpillar of mold.
Okay.
The reason that people like grass in their yards is because grass can handle a certain amount of foot traffic. And
so can moss.
Not really. Well, it lichens can handle a certain amount.
I mean, actually, lichens are more resilient.
Yeah, I don't think that anything's as good as grass besides rocks. And out in Arizona, when I was visiting Bernie from Declare Your Independence, Ernie.
Okay, I thought you said Bernie.
I might have said Bernie.
We got Bernie, on the brain.
Bernie on the brain. Ernie, Ernest Hancock.
You're feeling the burn.
Declare your independence with Bernie Hancock.
I saw a lot of rock and sort of dirt front yards, and I thought that was
Like that.
Yeah. Well, you like it because you don't like grass.
I hate
grass. You hate to mow it. I just don't think you should have grass unless you need it.
But I do like some things that grow, like strawberries. It's that time of year again, Valentine's Day, meaning it's time to place your order at Sherry's Berries for your loved ones. Go to berries.com, use code FTL by clicking the microphone in the top right, and get delicious freshly dipped strawberries from Sherry's Berries starting at just $19.99. And you can double the berries for just $10, which I highly recommend. The more berries, the more fun. And they're so delicious. Dipped in white milk and dark chocolatey goodness, topped with chocolate chips, decorative swizzle, or nuts. Always excited to receive Sherry's Berries here at our studio. And you'll be excited, and your loved one will be excited to receive these as well. They're awesome. And it's hard to imagine anyone could be disappointed by these delicious chocolate-covered strawberries. But if, for whatever reason, someone you know does not like strawberries, Sherry's Berries has all kinds of interesting treats that they can sell you there over at berries.com, berries.com. Use code FTL after you click on the microphone up at the top right. That way they know that we sent you, and get your orders in as soon as possible on this. Valentine's Day is right around the corner, and this is a great way to make an impression. Don't get flowers. Those things are just going to die on you. These delicious and Everyone will love them.
I can say I'm disappointed by Sherry's Berries, and that is because last year you shared them with the co-hosts.
Right. They didn't make it.
Whoever was in charge of the management of the berries like really fell down the
job. I am sorry. They did not make it until this time of week. Like, we got them on Wednesday last week, so you just missed it by one day, Johnson. And you can't keep people away from Sherry's Berries. You just can't do that. Berries.com. Click the mic. In the top right, type in code FTL, Berries, BERRIES.com to Tim in Wyoming. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Tim.
Hey, guys.
Hey there.
How's it going? No weird stories tonight. Sorry. Just now you're talking about the water delivery systems.
Yeah.
And I heard part of, part of your last caller was saying something, talking about something that sounded exactly like what Frank Herbert had proposed in Dune, which is called a wind trap. And basically, it was a super cooled element with funnels, with basically a funnel, and the wind would blow through the funnel, and it would condense water, and you just basically get the pure water out of the air. But I mean, that's you could get it from other sources too. I mean, that's a really good idea. I think that for very very arid areas, that would probably be a really good thing to have. I'm surprised that Arizona and New Mexico and Texas and maybe even Mexico. I'm surprised they're not using them in Mexico or Africa.
Super cooling stuff's expensive, right?
Well, unless you use, I worked for a company in California for a short time that actually built superconducting circuits. And the super cooling and superconducting use a lot of electricity, but they're supposed technology. Now, I never actually saw any of the working models. I was an angel investor. The job that I did was finding angel investors. Now, I didn't
your salesman.
Get very many of them. Yeah, well, basically, I was kind of a salesman, I guess you call it. But now, I was looking at a large commission from one person. If he possibly invested, but he decided to back out because he said, it looks like it's about a 3-year return. He said, eventually I'll get my money back, but I'm looking for something higher risk and faster return. And I said, well, you're not going to get it.
Man, you want something faster return than 3 years.
Well,
see, this is the whole you have to have money to make money thing. I don't even understand a world where you're like, oh yeah, I can't have an investment where I don't double my money in 2.5 years.
Well, I don't know what he was looking at. I mean, his investment would have been about $175,000, and he had it. I mean, he still has it probably, but he could have easily invested it. But he just spent more money on women and drugs than he did on anything else. So I mean, he's a millionaire, but he can do whatever he wants.
Have I bought his album?
Money. No, he's. He's not famous. He's only infamous. Sorry to say. But,
he's acting like he's famous.
Tim, was there more you wanted to share tonight?
Well, that's pretty much all, but thanks for taking my call.
Thank you, Tim.
Night.
Appreciate hearing from you. What's the market going to look like when the government gets out of the way as far as water is concerned? This is a tricky one. Let's go to Dave. He's in Ohio. You're on Free Talk Live. Go ahead, Dave.
This is iLiberty Dave out of the chat window.
Hi,
and
Dave.
I don't think the government's ever going to get out of the way. I think that would be kind of silly to imagine that they're not going to legislate all those jobs into perpetual existence.
The idea here is in the future where people care about liberty and we don't want to have a monopoly over in charge of one of the most important things, as far as human life is concerned, what would that look like?
John Stossel did report on a municipality that gave up control over their water to another organization that basically they just turned it over. They privatized. It was still a monopoly.
But not what I was talking about.
They had some good results, though.
Stand by, Dave. Let's talk about where you're coming from on this. Free number here, 855-450-FREE. Join us on the radio. This is Free Talk Live.
Removing bad taste and odor from your drinking water is easy. Removing the bad stuff you don't taste is what ProPure does best. Water the way nature meant it to be.
clean, crisp, and refreshing. See the complete line of ProPure countertop, inline gravity, and household water filtration products. Visit your authorized ProPure dealer or ProPureUSA.com. That's ProPureUSA.com or call 800-544-3533.
So you've got to take a state construction license exam or certification. Can't decide on what books or what chapters to study? Discover right now how you can eliminate unnecessary books and wasted study time. At contractorexam.com, our study materials zero in on state-required test topics in an effective, multiple-choice format. So whether you're a plumber, electrician, general contractor, or other construction-related trade, contractorexam.com will help get you prepared. Visit us at www.contractorexam.com today.
I'm Ian Freeman, host of Free Talk Live. We've been covering Uber for years on the radio with their ongoing legal cases across the globe defending your right to give people rides without asking government permission. I wanted to support Uber more directly, so I signed up to be a driver. It's fun to meet new people and help Uber push forward innovation. As of this recording, Uber is active in 67 countries, so there's a good chance they're available in your area. If you'd like to drive for Uber and make some money helping people get where they want to go, sign up at drive.freetalklive.com and you'll get a $100 bonus after you complete a certain number of trips. With Uber, you can drive anytime you want. You set your schedule. To get started, you need a good driving record, four-door vehicle, insurance, registration, and to pass a background check. It costs nothing to sign up, so visit drive.freetalklive.com. That's drive.freetalklive.com. And if you just want to try Uber as a rider, visit ride.freetalklive.com. Your first ride's free.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolf. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
LRN.fm is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for lrn.fm in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate us 5 stars, then share the link on your social media and let your friends and family know how you're listening to lrn.fm. Download it now, free, at apps.lrn.fm.
The Free State Project is an agreement among 20,000 participants to move to New Hampshire for liberty in our lifetime. Now almost 95% to our goal, we are creating private solutions to public problems and creating a society that runs on voluntary interactions instead of coercion. We invite you to participate in our cause and be part of our upcoming conference, Liberty Forum 16. Liberty Forum is a premier liberty-oriented conference based in Manchester, New Hampshire, that attracts free thinkers from all over the world. Over the past 9 years, this 3-day conference has grown to attract distinguished speakers and organizations to discuss how to build a better society through free market solutions. This year, our headliner is Edward Snowden, live from Russia. To learn more about attending, exhibiting, and sponsoring this event, please go to nhlibertyforum.com. That's nhlibertyforum.com.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, and we are keeping an eye on the Democratic-Republican primary election numbers coming in. Politico.com has a good listing. They're doing it by the tenths of a percent, so you can see the numbers as they're adjusting here.
I like that.
Google is doing that. Oh, tenths of...
Tenths of a percent.
NHPR is not doing that.
NHPR is rounding. Yeah. Or actually, NHPR is getting it from the AP.
But they have now
Google's
moved...
doing tenths of a percent, too, but I think that they're rounding up on the hundredths of a percent, whereas... Okay. the political is rounding down. I don't know.
Could be. What were you saying there, Mark?
It looks like Hillary Clinton is now below 40%.
She is, and she's been falling over segment of our show. She's gone down from like 39.7 to 39, what now is 39.3%, according to Politico.
I've got 39.2, according to Google, so that's weird.
38.7% reporting in the Democratic primary, 38% reporting in the Republican. With Donald Trump,
I've got 39% reporting on Google.
Well, I haven't hit refresh. I don't know if it's auto refreshing.
Donald Trump has basically doubled the next closest, which is Kasich.
He's almost gotten the combined next three candidates. If you look at the scores of the next candidates, nice. Trump has almost gotten almost beat all three of them combined.
Donald Trump with 33.8%.
He's a lot more fun to watch when he's winning.
Let's go back to the phones, though. We've been talking about water and what the supply of water would look like without this government monopoly. And Dave, you're saying the government's never going to give this up. There's no chance that we'll ever see this and the monopoly end.
Well, I think in general, it's just a fantasy to think they're ever going to give up before they're completely exhausted.
Oh, yeah, they're not going to give up. There's no doubt about that. But that doesn't mean they won't fail because ultimately, like you said, they're exhausted. Or we can vote to change the system. Here in New Hampshire, the system can actually be changed from the inside, unlike most places, probably including Ohio.
Okay, a business model exists for this already.
All right.
Now, I confess to not knowing who owns all the pipelines, but many of the oil and gas pipelines around the country are privately owned.
Mm-hmm. Yep, it's true.
And, they do not refine gasoline in every region. They pump it from region to region. And just understanding the volume of these pipes and such, and knowing that, I've heard it many times before, that generally every gas station is selling the same fuel out of the same pipeline. They're just getting it from a different distributor at the end of the pipeline.
They don't pump gasoline through pipelines. Gasoline comes delivered through trucks. It's too volatile to go through pipelines. What they do is they pump the oil, and they'll heat it to pump it through those pipelines.
So you don't think they ever send refined product through pipelines?
I don't think they send gasoline. That sounds like a terrible idea, doesn't it? How close do you want to live to the pipeline that has gasoline in it?
but I believe I remember pipeline gasoline fires. I think they do ship.
Don't they call those pipeline gasoline explosions?
I looked up the wiki before I called you, and the wiki mentioned refined products such as gasoline.
I could then you know what? I do not. When wiki is when someone calls upon the name of wiki, I will back off.
Okay, well, I'm not witnessing for wiki here. Okay, so let's step aside on this.
Yeah.
The other obvious point is the pipes are already in the ground in front of your house, unless you have a well. I mean, all of these people in Michigan, the pipes are already there. So it stands to reason that you could have a distribution system where you have several suppliers located throughout the city who are pushing water into the pipeline and, rating systems, testing, whatever. The public knows who is producing the best water and choose who to pay.
So the city has the existing grid, but the grid isn't sort of stopped off in different areas. The problem is that.
But are you saying the city can own property? Because this would not be consistent with the nature of this program.
No, I'm not claiming the city has you're saying the pipelines exist. And what
The
water lines exist, and that is clearly a correct statement. Water lines exist. However, the water lines exist in a way that a monopoly can deliver water from them to the houses. It doesn't exist two or three or four competitors might be able to pump water in and then get their water to the house that wants their water. That's a completely logistically different scenario. I mean, they could all pump in water like electric companies all pump electricity onto the grid, and then they just charge you for what happens to go into your house.
Plural, you said electric companies. Yes, there are many electric companies that produce electricity and pump it into the grid, singular.
Yep.
That is the same thing that I'm saying could happen with
water.
But
you couldn't distinguish your water as good or bad from your competitor. You could basically just say, this is our pricing model. Our pricing model is better than our competitor's pricing model. And you also have a situation where your competitor may have a bad product, and then that's going to reflect poorly on you. So if, for instance,
I disagree. The market chooses. The market chooses, and here's how. A fine example, I don't know if it's there where you are, but some states, when you go in a restaurant, there's a cleanliness report that they all have to post.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Okay.
A government cleanliness report.
Now, I'm not suggesting a system where people have to post things, but private companies can do water analysis of what's coming from each supplier.
Sure.
And in the marketplace, we each as individuals can choose to pay or not pay a certain supplier if we're connected to the water grid, which then gives us the power of voting with our dollars to push somebody out of the marketplace that's a bad producer, that's the worst quality producer of the lot.
Yeah, all I'm saying is that if I'm in a marketplace with Mark's Water Company competing against the Flint Water Company, and the Flint Water Company has a catastrophic lead poisoning situation that occurs, especially when you're talking about legacy pipes that are still in the ground, and it's going to negatively affect me because I can't actually deliver to my clients a higher quality of water. I can only compete against I can only basically work with Flint to fill the pipes, right?
Right, I agree.
Okay, so that's one problem that exists.
Yep.
You know, that's all.
Okay, so here's another issue. Here's the bigger issue. Here's the non-aggression principle issue. And that is, how is a pipe buried across your land, how is that an initiation of force? How does that create a victim?
So if I were to come to your land, dig up your yard and put a pipe through because I want to ship some water to your neighbor, you're claiming that that's not aggression?
Well, I'm saying that I'm not happy when it snows. I'm not happy when it rains. I'm not happy when a car goes by and splashes water in my yard. But the question is, does that rise to the point of an initiation of force?
Digging up your yard? I think most people would agree that that is an initiation of force on someone's property.
I had it happen, actually, when I was living in Sarasota. The town had to come through, and just they were relaying water lines, and they came in. They dug my whole front yard up, ripped up my sprinkler system, and the whole deal.
Okay, well, I'm not rationalizing what they did necessarily, but what I am saying is I don't think I've ever heard a compelling argument, for example, for why somebody walking across your back 100 acres across the corner of your land, how it creates a victim in you.
Walking's a little different than tearing up someone's yard to lay a pipe, wouldn't you say?
Yes, but it is a common argument that property rights is the right to the exclusive use of the property, and if you don't want to see Mr. Smith cutting across 3 feet of your 100 acres.
You also have to demarcate the property as well. Otherwise, it's unreasonable to think someone would have known.
And community standards sort of matter. Here in New Hampshire, we have something called current use. So most land, most people that have more than 10 acres have their land in current use, which means that you can hike on it and that sort of thing. You can even pick some berries as long as you're not like picking their berry bushes, but you could even, you could do a little berry picking or pick their fiddleheads or whatever you wanted to do. So the community standards here are that you're allowed to hike on people's land, whereas...
Do you accept that as a voluntary principle?
I accept that, I think that if you have enough land and somebody isn't making, they're not making a mess or anything like that, and you haven't posted...
Again, if it's
trespassers will be shot on sight.
If it's posted and you've demarcated the barriers, if there's some, not only just a posting, if there's a fence further, then obviously you're then crossing into someone's land and they might have a problem with that. But otherwise they don't if they haven't said they have a problem.
My thought here is that if you own the 100 acres, it's probably going to be poo and piglet walking across your land. And if you come out blasting, you're going to make a lot of unhappy kids.
Dave, thanks for your call tonight, man. I appreciate it. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. The number's shifting dramatically, at least as far as what we've been watching here. As dramatic as they can with 42% reporting. But it was, when we started the segment, it was Hillary Clinton with like 39.3%.
Right.
It's now 38.4% because out of nowhere,
I got 38.2.
Out of nowhere, R. De La Fuente has shot up to 1% of the Democratic vote. And that's where I think some of Hillary's percentages went towards. And Bernie Sanders solidly at 58.9.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
There comes a time when you need custom embroidered or screen printed apparel for your business, organization, or a special event. Corporate Casuals has been helping people create great looking logoed apparel for over 25 years. They can produce a single piece or thousands using name brand apparel like Nike, Patagonia, Adidas, and Hanes. Create your logo in their online embroidery design studio or upload your existing logo and they'll turn it into embroidery. Go to corporatecasuals.com/FTL and include FTL in the order notes and save 5% on your order.
As if chlorine in our water weren't bad enough, now they're adding ammonia?
It's true. Some municipalities are now adding ammonia plus chlorine to your water supply. It's a disinfectant called chloramine. But with a trusted Big Berkey water filter, you can keep chloramine out of your water. New NSF EPA certified lab tests show EPA Berkey water filters remove chloramines, pharmaceuticals, BPA, pesticides, bacteria and viruses, all forms of fluoride, and much more. Big Berkey water filters are the original and most trusted on the market. The gold standard in water purification. And our filters last for years at less than 2 cents per gallon. Big Berkey, the one that's powerful enough to purify stagnant pond water. Get your Big Berkey today. Call 1-877-99-BERKEY or click BigBerkeyWaterFilters.com. That's 1-877-99-BERKEY. Big Berkey water filters for the love of clean water.
The Free State Project has reached its goal of 20,000 liberty lovers who've pledged to move to New Hampshire and get active to achieve liberty in our lifetime. Perhaps you're trying to figure out what part of New Hampshire should be your destination. If so, consider Keene. You'll find more than 150 reasons to move to Keene at move.freekeene.com. Keene is famous for its historic, publicity-generating activism, as well as being the liberty media capital of the world. It's home to freekeene.com, New Hampshire's destination for liberty activism, news, and opinion. For years, we've been compiling over 150 reasons to move to Keene at move.freekeene.com, where you'll learn about some of what's happening here and what makes Keene a great place to live. If you love liberty, you'll probably enjoy anywhere you end up in the Shire. But do your due diligence first. Please visit move.freekeene.com for the full list of over 150 reasons to move to Keene. That's move.freekeene.com.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more.
It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
This is your Robertson Roberts Brokerage Daily Precious Metals Update. On Tuesday, gold is $2 higher at $1,192 per ounce. Silver is up 4 cents at $15.39 per ounce. Bitcoin is trading at $375. We're offering up to 200 Gold American Eagle 10th-ounce coins for $60 off the usual ounce price each. Call us and ask about this special at 800-874-9760 or visit us online at rrbi.co.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can join us here toll-free. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We've got Skype. Skype username's LRN.FM. There's still time for you if you want to jump in here and add to the discussion, whether it's about the New Hampshire presidential primary, which the results are still being tallied, not quite 50%. That's 43% on the Democratic side, with Bernie Sanders taking it solidly, 58.9% at the moment.
He head-cracked her. I mean, this is really something.
I was expecting it to be a pretty solid win for Bernie.
60% to her 38? I mean, it is huge.
And then there's a few write-ins below that. R. De La Fuente, the third-place candidate right now.
Beating, had some hackers on his side.
Beating De La Fuente beat O'Malley. De La Fuente with 0.9%, O'Malley with 0.3%, followed by Vermin Supreme. Supreme in fifth place, my candidate of choice, Furman Supreme, who is awesome.
De La Fuente, so it's like one district was 100% De La Fuente.
Well, that's what was weird. The percentages of the reporting percentage just barely increased, maybe like 1% or something, and all of a sudden De La Fuente jumped up from being a nobody candidate to nearly 1%. And that's one of the things that helped, or that, you know, pushed Hillary Clinton down solidly below 40% was De La Fuente coming up there. So, you know, I don't know why that happened. Maybe it was this guy was super popular in one district, or maybe somebody was just holding on to the votes and they just hadn't reported them all yet from various different districts. But I don't know. I don't get it. So that maybe that'll bode well for Vermin Supreme, who has now cracked 100 votes in this Democratic primary. On the Republican side, Donald Trump, 33.8% of the votes.
Doubling his next closest challenger, Kasich.
With Kasich with 15.9%, followed by Cruz, Bush. And Cruz and Bush are like in a dead heat here, 11.8% for Cruz. Yeah. Bush, 11.4%, which is really impressive. I mean, given...
And Rubio's pretty close to those numbers, too.
You've got to give Bush...
It's a three-way tie for last here.
You got to give Bush credit, given the tough time he's had since he's come here to New Hampshire. The Onion reporting... plunging into a downward spiral of despair and self-doubt after a poor showing in the Iowa caucuses, a demoralized Jeb Bush reportedly succumbed this week to New Hampshire's ongoing heroin epidemic. Quote, unfortunately, Jeb has suffered a number of significant career setbacks and personal humiliations recently, which left him depressed and highly susceptible to the allure of the cheap and widely available heroin in the rural Northeast, said political analyst James Peek, adding that the former Florida governor began experimenting with a Schedule I narcotic after a string of weak debate performances and a steady decline in his nationwide poll numbers, and had last been seen injecting 200 milligrams of black pearl, white black pearl while squatting in a condemned Manchester tenement.
And The Onion is a satirical online magazine. People.
Quote, stress, low self-esteem, and hopelessness are serious risk factors for substance abuse. And like many other people in New Hampshire right now, Jeb's recent struggles have left him feeling that drugs are his only chance of relief. Hopefully his campaign can find a way to get him into rehab and back on his feet before Super Tuesday.
No, no, no.
At press time, a senior Bush advisor confirmed that the candidate had climbed in the New Hampshire polls after generously sharing a needle with several fellow addicts. I wonder if his daughter
Heroin
was included.
Heroin addicts don't vote.
I wonder if his daughter was included because, you know, this is satire, but the reality is when we were living down in Florida, his daughter got busted for, I believe it was crack cocaine possession.
I think it was too,
yeah. And then, you remember when she was actually in the rehab, she ran away from the rehab and
had to go get her some more
and relapsed.
No, no.
And remember, Jeb Bush's response back then was, this is a family matter.
Yeah.
We'd appreciate it if the media would just leave us alone. This is a family matter. Whereas everybody else who gets busted for crack cocaine, who's not the daughter of a governor, goes to jail. They go and they get a criminal record.
Now she's probably on bath salts and crocodile.
Toll free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. So there's the Onion latest on the presidential primary. As we continue, let's go to Neil. He's in Arizona. And Neil, you're on Free Talk Live. Go ahead.
Yeah, buddy, this is a follow-up call to your last phone call when you were talking about gasoline and how it's delivered.
Yes, sir.
As a retired gasoline tanker driver...
There we go.
I can tell you there are literally thousands and thousands of miles of pipelines pumping gasoline across this country underground.
I'm wrong if I'm wrong. Thank you for calling in, sir.
Did you want to share more with us?
Has there been any problems?
No.
Explosions?
No. Well,
anything?
I heard somebody made the arbitrary comment that, all gasoline is delivered by truck.
Oh, I thought it was.
No, it's not.
There are websites here that, that back me up, but I believe you
if
you say it.
Consider yourself corrected. Thank you, Neil, for the call tonight. I appreciate it. Let's go also to Arizona, where James is on the line. James, go ahead.
Yes, when John Wesley Powell explored Arizona on the government dime after the Civil War, he said that no man would ever live in such a desolate desert. But thanks to what he couldn't imagine, thanks to dams named after Roosevelt, Hoover, Coolidge, not to mention the world's biggest man-made lake, now named after him, millions of people live in a county in the middle of the desert that is populated by, again, millions of people, much bigger than your whole state of New Hampshire in that BS primary you're just talking about, and that's irrelevant, if I might say. So it's irrelevant.
That's why you've got all the major mainstream media here reporting on it, because it's irrelevant.
Maricopa County has millions more people in it than it the state of New Hampshire does.
Yeah.
New Hampshire, remember President Patrick Buchanan? Neither do I.
James.
But anyway, Johnson writes, cognitive dissonance it may cause. What say you that millions of people live in the middle of the desert thanks to collectivism and dams built on other people's money?
So the people who built those dams just did it out of the goodness of their heart?
I didn't say anything of the effect. Now, what does it say about...
People aren't able to voluntarily do things together without it being collectivism and being enforced at gunpoint?
It violates the non-aggression principle. Millions of happy residents live in the middle of the desert thanks to the Salt River Project.
I agree with you. The government creates complications.
So people can't pull it together and voluntarily dig a hole. It has to be done at gunpoint.
Wait a minute. I thought James was a libertarian.
No, wait. I thought you were against the non-aggression principle or for it.
I thought you were a libertarian, James.
I am, but that doesn't mean that I'm anti-statist or anti-collectivism.
And so you're not in favor of the non-aggression principle.
Bringing water to your fellow human being.
So wait, you're just not in favor. You call yourself a libertarian, but you aren't in favor of non-aggression?
I'm challenging you to come up with how it's grossly violative of your non-aggression principles that you hold dear, that millions of people live in the state of Arizona thanks to government expenditures.
Well, people live all over the world because of government expenditures.
I mean, that's the way the system works right now. You, like, just waking up to this fact?
I mean, a lot of people wore cotton that was picked by slaves. That doesn't make slavery okay.
Hey, I want to thank James. James,
this is a great call.
A compliment.
Can we step down for a second?
I'd like to compliment you, James. I'd like to compliment you. Thank you for this call. I think you've been a very good caller tonight.
You're a scumbag, too.
All right. Well, thank you for the call tonight. So I'm trying to compliment James, but he keeps talking. Yeah. Anyway, I'm going to put him on hold so maybe he can hear it. I just want to say thank you to James for being on topic tonight and like being relevant. Mm-hmm. And you don't have to be on topic when you call Free Talk Live, but James is notoriously talking about things that happened in the past usually when he calls. So thank you for being on a topic we talked about tonight. But you can also bring up anything you want as well. So you can do that. It's just that it doesn't make sense when you talk about stuff that happened in the past on the show.
It was sort of relevant. Yeah. It was all encapsulated. People could understand where he was coming from.
It was challenging.
Challenging for the hosts. No problem there.
So thank you, James, for that call. It was a good one. Appreciate it.
The people of Flint also got their poison supplied to them through collectivism. You know,
that's true.
A lot of people are existing because of things that happen because of the government. People are driving around on government roads. People are doing lots of things that happen based on collectivism. That doesn't mean that collectivism was required to make those
things
happen.
It presumes that those things wouldn't have happened in the absence of the government force. And I'm sorry, but look, you can see the examples of people who've decided to repair their own streets without asking government permission to do that. The government gets mad. They attack them for it. They arrest them for it. They threaten them. And the people, given the opportunity to keep the money that they earn, they can allocate that money in a more effective manner than can the government.
James is kind of stuck in this situation where he's got this sort of circular logic loop going on for him, you know, where it's like, well, everything's under the government, and therefore everything has to be under the government. It's like, no. That's the way it's been, but, you know, with enough effort, that cycle can be broken.
So it looks
cycle of abuse.
It looks like a done deal. The cycle of abuse, of course, is going to continue from the federal government, where whoever it is that wins this election, whether it's Bernie Sanders, Donald Trump, or someone else, because, again, just because they win New Hampshire doesn't mean that they will ultimately be the selection of the entire country or enough people to qualify for the final ballot, the general election here. But nonetheless, right now, Bernie Sanders trouncing Hillary Clinton in the Democratic primary with 48% reporting, and Donald Trump trouncing the remainder of the Republican candidates, with Rand Paul not even getting more than the total number of write-in votes. We'll see you tomorrow night online in the meantime at freetalklive.com.
Markets went into a frenzy today after the price of money suddenly skyrocketed to $90 a dollar. Onion reporter spoke to economics professor Mark Cosgrave about the soaring cost of U.S. currency and the impact of increasingly unpredictable dollar-to-dollar rates.
Right now, money prices are steeply rising with no signs of slowing down. This morning alone, the price of dollars nearly tripled, with 1 cent worth approximately $6. That's exponentially higher than even a week ago when money was trading at roughly $53 on the dollar. To put it bluntly, we're now in the midst of a national economic crisis.
According to Cosgrave, the abrupt spike in dollar prices initially caused many Americans to hold onto their money, hoping that the $90 cost of dollars would soon dip back down. But as prices continued to climb, investors panicked and began purchasing as much money as possible.
But with the cost of quarters hitting $4.97 and the $5 bill jumping to a 12-year high of $372, the days when you could get $30 or $40 for just a couple of bucks are unfortunately long gone.
This is the Onion News Network.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate.
Oof, I think we've all had enough of that jingle, don't you? If you're going to invest in property in New Hampshire, it just makes sense to support a liberty-friendly realtor. Call Mark Warden of Team Porcupine Real Estate for investment property or rentals in the Free State, or visit his website. Come on, you know it.
PorcupineRealEstate.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
Rebel Love Show is next, live after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Darrell W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Tuesday, February 9th, 2016. Silver is trading at $15.34 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,197 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $376. Antiwar.com reports, fulfilling a campaign pledge to end his nation's involvement, Canadian Prime Minister Justin Trudeau has announced that all Canadian airstrikes against the Islamic State in Iraq and Syria will end by February 22nd at the latest. Trudeau campaigned heavily last year on his promise to end Canadian airstrikes, a position that grew in popularity amid reports that the Canadian Defense Ministry had covered up allegations of civilians killed in the airstrikes. Among the Canadian airstrikes, the deadliest to be made public was an attack against a dairy, which Canadian officials claimed was a weapons factory. That strike killed 10 civilian workers and wounded 20 others. Though the U.S. was seen as annoyed at Canada ending its airstrikes, the Pentagon on Monday ignored the report and instead announced that Canada had promised to triple the number of ground troops they are committing to northern Iraq. At present, Canada has up to 70 ground troops in Iraq, so the tripling will mean at most another 140 Canadian troops. Canadian trainers have been involved in some high-profile clashes with the Islamic State troops in the past, though are believed to have been moved back away from the frontier since then. For nearly 40 years, Roberts & Roberts Brokerage has been a trusted source for buying and selling precious metals like gold and silver. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and have permanently removed the minimum purchase amount for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on buying and selling precious metals and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 800-874-9760 or visit online at rrbi.co. UPI reports a winter storm is expected to bring 3 to 8 inches of snow throughout most of Massachusetts, as neighboring New Hampshire could see some snow ahead of presidential primaries. Blizzard conditions are expected in Cape Cod, southeastern Massachusetts, and its islands. Many schools in the state, including those in Boston, Cambridge, Arlington, Chelsea, Salem, and Barnstable, were not open on Monday. Massachusetts Governor Charlie Baker closed state offices in eastern Massachusetts for non-emergency personnel in anticipation of the storm. Some cities in Massachusetts introduced parking bans on Monday. In Boston, where between 8 to 12 inches of snow is expected, the snow began falling between 4 and 6 a.m., and the heaviest snowfall is predicted between 7 a.m. and 2 p.m. At least two flights have been canceled from Boston's Logan International Airport. In New Hampshire, where presidential primaries are scheduled for Tuesday, a snowstorm recently brought up to 10 inches of snow in some areas. A winter weather advisory is active throughout the state, with the possibility of light snowfall throughout much of New Hampshire on Tuesday. There is a 20% chance of precipitation on Tuesday in Manchester, the state's largest city, and a temperature of 29 degrees. In Woodstock, there's a 20% chance of snow and a 30-degree high. The Daily Decrypt is a Monday through Friday newscast about all the best news in cryptocurrencies and peer-to-peer networks. Know what's hot in the world of digital money, borderless trade, and cutting-edge communications. Available on YouTube, SoundCloud, and Facebook Video. The Daily Decrypt is the news of the future. Reuters reports a U.S. federal judge denied for the second time